This is UCLA and Cal State Fullerton. I'm Bill McDonald, and trust me, Tom Brown's UCLA. You haven't heard of him yet. He's on the outside. It is third down and about five for Fullerton. First series, Trendell Williams, the transfer from LA Valley, JC over center. In the ball. Lays it on the ground. Trendell picks it up. He's got some room across the 30. First down up to the 36-yard line. Trendell Williams gains 12 and a first down for Fullerton before Marvin Goodwin makes the stop.
Well, you're going to see what happens here. Trendell Williams coming up on a third down play. He's going to bobble the snap right there. And Chalinski, number 98, is right on his heels. But he outruns both Miller and Chalinski. And Trendell Williams doing a fine job getting up the field for the first down.
There's Trendell Williams, totaled 171 yards total offense in his first major college start last week. Scored a couple of touchdowns against Northridge, a 28-7 win for the Titans on first down. And once again, Trendell Williams keeps it. Matt Werner and Mike Chalinski in on the stop. Chalinski, the 6'4 senior from New Jersey, and there's Matt Werner, the 6'3 junior.
Well, you know the defense is fired up, especially when they play a wishbone team, knowing the opposition's going to run the ball an awful lot, the triple option threat. Right there, Miller coming in and Werner coming from the backside saying hello to Trendell Williams.
One thing that Fullerton wants to do, establish the middle, and they think maybe they can work the middle of UCLA. They want to see how disciplined the defensive linemen are. That's what you have to do against a triple option offense. You have to be very disciplined on defense. On second down, out of the bone again. This time give it up the middle to Tim Ryan, and he is going nowhere on the middle of the UCLA line. Arnold Ale. 6'2", 224-pound senior from Carson. The Mike or the weak linebacker, the defensive star and the leader. He makes the stop and sets up a third down for Fullerton.
Well, you mentioned they're going to try the middle of the field, and the fullback is ever so important in the triple option threat, and Ryan right there just getting stuffed in the middle.
Passing situation will be third down and 12. Trendell Williams threw the ball only seven times last week, completed four for a total of 93 yards. He's got three wide receivers, two to the right side. In motion, Jermaine Hill. And we've got flags down. A dead ball penalty. Cal State Fullerton, first possession of the ball game. Fullerton last week beat Northridge. This is the opener for UCLA, and oh, have they been antsy. There's Gene Murphy, 13 years at Fullerton. This is going to go 5 yards against the Titans. It'll be third down and 17 on the dead ball foul. Crowd of around 35, maybe 40,000 here at the Rose Bowl.
Third and 16.
One thing the Titans can't do, Tom, lay the ball on the ground. They did it four times last week. And a bone team will lay it on the ground, but just those silly ones that you want to stay away from.
And I think also they want to avoid long third down situations like they have right now.
On third down, pressure, and down goes Trendell Williams. Mike Chalinski with the sack back, hopefully for another healthy season. And it'll be a punting situation for the Titans.
Loss of 3 yards.
They're going to see Trendell Williams really never getting any time at all. Chalinski right by his man, Danny Garcia, who's really considered the best blocker up front for Cal State Fullerton.
One thing that UCLA will be able to do, rush the passer. They will have a tremendous pass rush. Noel Prefontaine, a freshman and a good one. The left foot kick, not one of his better efforts. Bound out of bounds at about the 45-yard line. We've got a scuffle brewing at about the 35. That was a 28-yard boot by the freshman Prefontaine. And there is a flag back down at the 25-yard line of Fullerton that we'll check.
Al Jordan right there just happened to be back on the field. He's had to
penalty is indicated against the Titans.
This should be a penalty that UCLA might refuse because of the poor kick. They will have first down at the 45, their own 45. This is a makeup game, of course, for both of these teams after Cal State Long Beach dropped football last year. And for Cal State, Fullerton, what a wonderful opportunity to play here in the Rose Bowl and play against a team
offense,
like UCLA. Next week, they'll have to go
first
between
down,
the hedges and play
UCLA.
Georgia, which lost a thriller today to Tennessee. And as I suspected, UCLA will refuse the penalty. and take the ball. And there is Wayne Cook. Boy, the spotlight is on this youngster. 6'3", the sophomore from Newberry Park, has yet to throw a pass in college ball. Sean LaChapelle, the All-American, the go-to guy. And we'll see if Cook and LaChapelle can get some of that magic that Maddox and Sean have. On first down, Kevin Williams in the eye, two receivers to the left. Play action, Cook, first pass in college, is complete. LaChapelle wide open, and he's got room. First down and more, down to the 24-yard line. Cook to LaChapelle, 31 yards.
Well, I don't think you could ask for a better start for Wayne Cook. He comes out, and they're going to play action a little bit to Kevin Williams inside, and who do they come to? Naturally, number 88, and he's just playing against air out there. No one's even near him. Sean does make a fine catch. He turns it up the sideline, does a great job running with the ball. Takes about four guys to bring him down.
The first one there, B.B. Hudson, the 5'9 senior. First down at the 24. Gift to Kevin Williams. Can't get outside. Tripped up nicely there by number 29, Cardell Avery, who's starting instead of Al Witt at the free safety spot. Cardell, the 6'1", 190-pound senior, Long Beach State transfer. There are a couple of ex-49ers on this Titan team. If the Titans have a strength, Tom, it's defensively. They'll fly around at you. They play that Washington-type defense. It'll bring 8-9 guys on the line at times. Khalif Carter is the fullback. Williams, halfback in the eye. Fumble. The exchange between Cook and Williams misfired. Kevin Williams falls on it at about the 26, but that'll set up a third and long for UCLA. And Cook says, my fault.
You mentioned Khalif Carter in the lineup also. He's had some nagging injuries. He's had an Achilles heel that's been bothering him some. And Coach Terry Donahue, I know, was concerned about Khalif's availability, but right there, a good sign him starting the game.
Well, Khalif Carter, it's going to be nagging him all season long. He heard it back in spring ball, and if it's not healed now, Donahue is reserved to the fact that it's going to be bothering him the entire year. Wide receivers are split out of the eye on third and long, third and 12 for UCLA. Cook throws in and out of the hands, almost intercepted. Kearney Johns had it, dropped it, flag down. That was intended for the tight end Rick Daly. And Kearney Johns, originally signed as a DB, shows some good skills covering. He's one of the outside linebackers in this scheme. And that's going up against UCLA. And we'll see if Fuller accepts, because it would set up a fourth down if they refuse.
Question the call somewhat. Third and 12, and you do play action to Kevin Williams. I know Kevin Williams is a great back. He led the Pac-10 a year ago in rushing. But third and 12, you might have Wayne just come out and throw a quick hitter, although he was trying to get the ball to Rick Daly.
Ineligible receiver downfield for UCLA is declined, and it will be fourth down. You know, when you haven't played a game, everything, the first series is so fast, and the butterflies are flying around so quickly, aren't they? I mean, you've been there.
Oh, absolutely. Wayne, I'm sure he didn't even realize it was third down, and he probably didn't care that a play-action pass was called, but right now they're going to give a chance to Luis Perez.
And Perez had a sensational year last year, especially down the stretch. 10 out of 12 his last five games. This will be a 43-yarder. Luis Perez.
Perez. Attempted field goal. Jeff Clark to hold.
Jeff Clark will hold. Spot at the 33. Perez to give UCLA the lead. And he's got it. Luis Perez knocks one down for 43 yards, and with 9:05 to play in the first quarter, UCLA on top, 3-0.
Today in California, 350,000 people improve their inner selves. 3 million improve their outer ones. The Karuk Tribe Health Center got a Pacific Bell-centric system and a promise to maintain it at no extra cost for life. Jeff Thompson got his lawn painted. It's just another day in California. Tomorrow will be better.
This is my third Honda. I had the little hatchback, another Accord. It's my second Honda.
Honda Accord, all the way.
Civic Del Sol.
Actually, I just moved up to an Accord for my Civic.
After this one, it's another Honda.
It's almost paid off. I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Wonderful, wonderful car. I wouldn't buy anything else, ever.
Welcome back to the Rose Bowl. 3-0 UCLA on a 43-yard field goal by Luis Perez just a couple of moments ago as we are nearly 6 minutes into the ball game. And the Bruins will be kicking off once again. UCLA 9-3 last year. Hancock Bowl win over Illinois. 6-2 in the conference, tied for second. There's Terry Donahue, his 17th year at his alma mater. 16 years, he's won 9 games 8 times. Pagny will kick it off again as he did to start the game. As I mentioned, we'll see Eric Wright Jr. also a little bit later on. Luis Perez not handling the kickoff chores this year, although he just racked one up from 43 yards. And Arthur Davis will be back once again for Fuller.
Arthur Davis back deep.
Davis returned one last week for 19 yards. Last year he averaged 20 plus and change on his returns. A low line drive going to be taken by the short man at the 20 yard line. It's Reggie Carter. Carter moves the ball all the way up to the 35 yard line. So good field position for Trendell Williams and Cal State Fullerton. And there is Trendell. These are not new uniforms, by the way. The new uniforms, which look conspicuously like the New York Giants, were unveiled last week at the beautiful new Titan Stadium, seats 10,000 down at Fullerton. But because of the budget, a lot of people know about the budget crunch and problems at Cal State Fullerton. These are the old ones. That's last week's numbers for Trendell.
They do have new helmets, though.
It still has a New York Giant look to it. This is the double slot formation that you'll see. Tim Ryan right behind Trendell. Williams still with the football. Lots of room to run. He's going to gain about 8 yards out to the 43-yard line before Marvin Goodwin came over from the safety position to drag him down. So the Bruins that time fooled by the belly fake. And Trendell had some room left side for a good first down gain. It'll be second down and 2.
Right there, Williams really riding the fullback for an extra long time that time, and that's where they want him. The offensive coordinator, Jim Chaney, loves Trendell Williams in air. Marv Goodwin with a fine tackle.
One thing Cal State Fullerton wants to do, shorten this ball game. They will wait for the time clock to go all the way down till it's almost expired, and they will run the football a lot. They figure the less time UCLA has their hands on it, the better chance they have to win. Second down, Ryan. Got the first down out to the 45-yard line. Wrapped up there by Jameer Miller, who played strictly in the nickel package last year. Now he is an every down linebacker.
Well, Jameer Miller right there really just welcoming the task and taking on the fullback right there, delivering a blow to Tim Ryan, all about 5'10 and 220 against 6'4 and 230.
You and I have been following Jameer ever since we saw him in the Shrine All-Star game a couple of years ago, and we know that he is the next potential big play linebacker, maybe in the conference.
That's right. The greatest thing about Jameer Miller, I read in the press guide that Mark Dillon's, the SID, put together for UCLA, 6% body fat. And I remember seeing him at the Shrine camp. Bill McDonald and I walked up, and he was eating 2 chocolate glazed donuts
with some fries on the side. And it's only 6% on the body fat. You love guys like that, don't you? First down, out of the double slot again. Tim Ryan straight behind. Steve Danzy, Arthur Davis, the running back. Long count, Davis in motion. Trendell Williams once again gives it up the middle. And the same combination, Tim Ryan with the football, Jameer Miller with the tackle. So Jameer reading it well so far on the give to the fullback. Gain of 3, second and 7.
Well, one of the other cogs in the defense right now, Bruce Walker, number 49, not playing this evening with a hamstring pull. Saleh Asaya, one of the big people up front for the Bruins.
Bruce Walker won't be ready for 2 to 3 weeks to really be an impact player on that defensive line for UCLA. Double slot. Wide receiver each side of the field. Williams has room left again across midfield. First down and more, all the way down to the 28-yard line of UCLA. Trendell Williams, 29-yard. And Bradley Craig finally brought him down. First down, Fullerton.
Well, watch Trendell Williams. He opens up to the right side and all of a sudden reverses field. Just a little misdirection used by Fullerton, and Trendell Williams, once again, a great athlete. He really is a solid player coming in from LA Valley JC. And right there, number 35, Bradley Craig, great pursuit angle, hustling down to tackle Williams.
Already 43 yards on six carries for number 16. And Fullerton threatening, down 3-0, 6:40 clock running, first quarter. Man in motion. The pitch is to Arthur Davis. And he's going to be run down and out of bounds. Ofello Henderson. The 6-foot, 198-pound junior and a big-time talented safety makes the stop.
Well, Ofello coming from middle or center field, as I like to call it, free safety position. Jameer getting a good hit on Williams, and Arthur Davis nowhere to run. That's what UCLA needs right now, a big play defensively.
Ofello Henderson, get this, he's only the fifth starter at free safety for UCLA since 1977, following Easley, Rogers, Washington, and Turner, all great names. Double slot, two wide receivers left. Second and 11. Davis in motion. Flag down. Trendell Williams runs into his own man. Mike Shalinski botched up that play. Fumble. UCLA's got the football. Marvin Goodwin picked up the loose ball, but we have whistles, and we'll see if the flag, if it's a dead ball foul, there'll be no fumble. If it's on Fullerton, it's UCLA's football. We're giving you all the options. It's on Fullerton. Refused. The fumble stands. Bruins ball. Big break for UCLA early on. And what a disappointment for Fullerton as they were moving the football.
Well, right here, the ball's going to pop out. You're going to see Trendell. He was trying to give it to Ryan. The ball pops out. Marv Goodwin right there recognizing it. And the side judge comes in and makes the call, a fine call by the officials.
Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, said we can accept a bad pitch or maybe a fumble bobble, but plays like that or fumbling while running or a center exchange, we cannot accept. They laid the ball on the ground four times, they being Fullerton last year, and it hurt them right there. First down for UCLA at the 30, Wayne Cook. Give it to Kevin Williams. Burst through the middle for good yardage all the way out to the 38-yard line. And a good look at the senior from Spring, Texas. Stopped there by Cardell Avery. It'll be second down. And a long one for UCLA. There's a good look at Kevin Williams, the Pac-10 leading rusher. Nicked a little bit in camp this year. Bothered by an ankle. There are his numbers from last year. Over 1,100 yards. He was one of a trio of tailbacks used for UCLA last year. He is the man this year.
Kevin Williams averaging 6 yards of carry, not 16.
Up the middle, Khalif Carter, minimal yardage, close to a first down. Mike Allen in there to plug it up. The 6'2 senior, transfer from Cerritos JC, was a part-time starter last year for Kirk Harmon's defense at Cal State Fullerton.
Bill, you mentioned Fullerton using the eight-man front, the University of Washington philosophy. Kirk Harmon really studying the Huskies up in the Northwest and seeing what they do well, and obviously putting a lot of men at the line of scrimmage.
It's the defense of the 90s. Everybody's doing it. Give it up the middle. First down and more up to the 46-yard line for Kevin Williams.
One of the problems is when you put a lot of men up at the line of scrimmage and you face a racehorse like Kevin Williams, if he busts a line of scrimmage right here, Khalif Carter getting a fine block. Kevin really just has one tier of blockers, or actually tacklers, to break his way through, and if he does that, look out, he may do it tonight.
The best way to attack this defense, run the option, which we may see UCLA do right here in this series. Also a lot of sprint draws. That might burst Williams out. Cook, quick drop. Hits LaChapelle again, his second reception, and he's running with the football. He's got lots of room down to the 35, something that LaChapelle does so well, running after the catch. 20 more yards for number 88, and a first down for UCLA. Darius Watson makes the stop.
Well, Sean LaChapelle, we mentioned it early on. He's got to get the ball. Wayne Cook got to get the ball to Sean LaChapelle right there. They're playing very far off of Sean, but really leaves two guys in the dust right there. He looks like he's had a fine fall camp and really come to play this fall.
La Chapelle, who was this close to going to the pros last year, 15 minutes before the press conference, Rick Neuheisel was the one that talked him out of it. Receivers coach for UCLA, Cook, plenty of time. Cuts it over the middle once again, complete down to the 20-yard line, and who else but Sean La Chapelle, 15 yards, and Darius Watson on the coverage, the second-team all-conference performer.
Right here, give a lot of credit up to the offensive line for giving Wayne a lot of time right there. Sean La Chapelle just looking into the window of the defense right there, facing a little zone defense, coming across, running a nice curl route, and Wayne sticking the ball right between his numbers.
And there are those impressive numbers of last season. Three wide receivers in this plan. Snoop to Williams, cuts back inside, not much room, gets inside the 20, down to the 18-yard line. Gain of three before Lorenzo Haley. Probably the second best linebacker Coach Murphy has ever seen at Fullerton makes the stop. The 5'11", 230-pound senior. The best linebacker, probably John Nevins. He's returning from a redshirt year as Lorenzo Haley out of the College of the Sequoias, J.C. Michael Wynn is the receiver to the right. La Chapelle left. On second down. On the delay this time to Kevin Williams. Going nowhere. And it will set up a third down. Big number 92, David Bruninger. Both these teams will shuffle in and out. A lot of performers. There's Gene Murphy. Well, he has seen it all at Fullerton, hasn't he? But things are looking good for him. And Terry Donahue is anxious to see what Wayne Cook could do. Everything Wayne has done so far has had Homer Smith behind him. Now he's on his own. Third down. Cook lofts it out into double coverage. La Chapelle up the ladder. Can't get it incomplete. Good coverage that time. Darius Watson, there he is. Gregarious Darius. He'll strut his stuff after he makes a play. He'll let you know. And it'll be fourth down for UCLA.
I think one of the problems UCLA faces with a young quarterback, Wayne Cook, he knows how good Sean La Chapelle is. Therefore, he's going to try and force a few balls right there. Sean being double covered. And we've seen him pull down a lot of balls in coverage previous to this and prior seasons, but not this time. Nice play by Darius Washington.
This is a 36-yard attempt for Luis Perez at the middle of the field. He's already hit one from 43. UCLA leads with 2:48 remaining in the quarter. Perez, six, Fullerton nothing. 2:44 remaining in the first quarter. And UCLA leads Fullerton by six. Don't go away. Back with more in a moment.
If you've discovered there's more to focus on in life than a standard driver's side airbag, discover all the safety features available in the all-new 1993 Toyota Corolla. And discover Corolla again.
A lot of different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Play your part.
Spectacular oceanfront view.
Blue Moon Saloon.
Romantic dinners and lunches served 7 days a week with sunset supper specials.
Blue Moon Saloon.
Excellent seafood paired with a friendly, efficient staff.
Blue Moon Saloon.
The incredible captain's quarters seating up to 150 people, complete with private bar, facilities, and a 15-foot screen. Blue Moon Saloon, Redondo Beach Marina on the water for great seafood, cocktails, and the best ocean view on the coast.
There's an old-fashioned bakery just around the corner where you'll find the highest quality of baked goods that taste as good as they look and a staff of friendly professionals dedicated to serve you. Where? At Torrance Bakery, of course.
From the traditional to the abstract, we have a large display of wedding cakes in our wedding cake showroom.
Torrance Bakery, an old-fashioned, friendly, full-service bakery in historic downtown Torrance. Treat yourself or someone special. You'll be glad you did.
Back at the Rose Bowl, it's opening night for UCLA. They lead Fullerton 6-0, and it's back. That's right, you wanted it, you got it. Chris Marlowe and the UCLA Sports Magazine are returning for a third season right here on Prime Ticket. It's highlights of all UCLA sports activities and a look inside Bruin Athletics. That's the UCLA Sports Magazine with the big side. Chris Marlowe, watching on Prime Tickets. Eric Wright now will kick it off. So our first look at him, the 6'2 junior from Palos Verdes, California. Terry Donahue searches for a kickoff man. And once again, Arthur Davis out of Brooklyn, New York, back standing at his own three. 6-0 UCLA, 2:44 remaining. First quarter, I'm Bill McDonough along with Tom Ramsey. Davis at the 8. Straight up the middle he goes, and down at the 28-yard line. Donnie Edwards with the stop.
We're going to see a nice picture of Jeff Clark here, number 11, a backup wide receiver. Nice soft hands by Jeff and really helping out Mr. Perez that time. Makes it look easy.
It's time for a plug. Jeff Clark, Corona Del Mar High School. There he is. My stomping grounds. Jeff Clark, a good sea king with the good hands. There he is, Newport Beach, California. But with CDM High, it's due. And it's 6-0. Trendell Williams sets up shop at the 28. Arthur Davis, Jermaine Hill, Tim Ryan, the setback. There's Davis in motion. And that was movement in the line, I believe, by Fullerton. And that will set them back 5 yards and set up a first and 15 for Cal State Fullerton.
Really what Coach Murphy doesn't want, mistakes on first down. You got to get some movement on first down when you're running the triple option.
Before the snap, false start, offense, still first down.
The Titans 2-9 last year, 1-6 in the conference. You know, they've only won 4 out of their last 24, but they have been beset by financial problems. In fact, a couple of years back, the program was actually dropped for 10 days, a black 10 days if you're a Fullerton fan, but things are back in. And when playing this game against UCLA certainly has helped financially, but they want to stay in there and play a good football game. First and 15. Arthur Davis in motion. The pitch goes to Davis. Cuts back inside, staying home that time. And Nikosi Littleton makes the stop for UCLA. Nikosi Littleton has won the war with Shane Jasper at that linebacker position for the Bruins. He's a 6'1 junior. There's Arthur Davis with the carry. And there is Nikosi. He plays the Mac backer spot in this defense, coordinated by Bob Field.
And when they say Mac backer, it's really the strong side inside linebacker. And Nikosi really made great strides throughout the spring and the fall practice.
2 minutes remaining. Clock running first quarter. Trendell Williams has had an excellent first period. A fumble hurt a Fullerton drive last time. Flags fly again as the give is to the fullback, Tim Ryan. And Rod Smalley, who's in there at a linebacker position, first one to meet him. And this one's going against UCLA.
Offsides indicated against UCLA.
So it will remain second down. Last week, Fullerton beat Northridge 28-7. They outgained the Matadors 386 to 150.
Defense lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Pretty impressive performance, but of course, Terry Donahue, to get his guys to take Cal State Fullerton seriously, all he had to do was say a couple of things. The Citadel over Arkansas. That big upset last week really woke up a lot of people.
Well, Coach Donahue is a great historian, and he will remind his players from time to time about great upsets of the past.
And that big upset hurt our producer, Dennis Kirkpatrick, immensely. He's still crying about it. Minute and a half to play here in the quarter. Oh, down goes Trendell Williams at the 30. No chance to pitch it because Rod Smalley in his face in a hurry. The most intense of all the outside backers. He'll get to you in a quick jump, and he did right there. Good play by Rod.
Well, once again, you saw the play worked for him going the other way early on before. It was the big play Trendell Williams ran. But this time, Rod Smalley doing a great job staying at home and making a fine play.
Third down for Fullerton. Third and 8, 6-0 UCLA. As all the pomp and circumstance out again for college football on a Saturday here at the Rose Bowl. Bruins will be back here in a couple of weeks. Marshall Faulk and San Diego State. Trendell Williams, nowhere to go. Down he goes at the 23-yard line.
Donnie Edwards
that time, number 23, doing a great job coming in. And this guy's a guy to watch this year. I watched him up at fall practice, and I tell you, I asked Coach Bob Field, the defensive coordinator, afterwards. I said, who is number 23? We didn't see him last year, but see a lot of him this year.
One thing about Donnie Edwards, he came into camp at 200 pounds. He's beefed up to 208, if you can call that beefing up. He's one of those guys that's got to get on that Jameer diet.
That's right.
Feed him a couple of donuts. High snap, Prefontaine comes down with it. La Chapelle back for UCLA. We'll just watch it. Whoa! La Chapelle absolutely drilled at the 30-yard line, but Sean did not call for a fair catch, so that's fair game. A 44-yard boot by Noel Prefontaine out of Oceanside. And we're going to slip away again right here. Do not move. 4 seconds remaining in the quarter. 6-0 Bruins.
Today in California, Gracie Balsam's improved her crawl stroke. Up in Wairika, 6 children of the Karooks learned the traditions of their ancestors. Pacific Bell worked on an advanced monitoring system that will help smooth out traffic jams in LA. Les Phillips built his dream car. It's just another day in California. Tomorrow will be better.
Every inch of the Lexus coupe was designed to exhilarate you. Even when you're not moving.
There's a dry chill blowing down from the Rockies. Coors Dry, double chilled for brewery fresh taste and a finish as clean as ice. Then delivered mountain cold to your store. It's not just a better dry. This is a better beer. Coors Dry. Feel the chill.
Mitsuba Notebooks, eminently suitable for mobile executive computing. For the latest in corporate power, buy the 486 notebook with a high-resolution 10-inch screen from Mitsuba.
That's Trendell Williams calling upstairs. He's played a good first quarter, just 4 seconds remaining in it. 6-0 UCLA, and I'll tell you what, this has proven a lot of people wrong so far. Fullerton playing with the big boys, Tom Ranger.
That's right. Well, without a doubt, they were excited to come in and play the Bruins.
First down for UCLA at the 31. Snap count by Cook almost draws a couple offside. It's Darren Washington and Kevin Williams in the backfield. Three wide receivers give it off to Kevin Williams, going nowhere. Good play that time by Randy Strickland. Big number 98, what a load he is. And that's the end of the first quarter. UCLA 6, Titans nothing.
You know what makes Harris Laughlin such a great deal right now? Besides that. Okay, I'll tell you. Right now you can stay at Harris Laughlin for a terrific room rate. Well, I was right. You're staying at Harris Casino Hotel in Laughlin, the only one with a beach. Great rooms, tasty restaurants, all that fun, the beach, and so affordable. You should get over here right now. Harris Casino Hotel Laughlin, the better people place. Call this number for reservations. And come see the sand, man.
Interestingly enough, there are approximately 1,500 minutes in a day, which means right now you can save about $1 a minute with a $1,500 factory cash offer on a new Geo Storm. And get all this. Don't let another day or 1,500 minutes tick away before you take advantage of the $1,500 dollar a minute rebate on a Geo Storm at your Southern California Chevrolet Geo dealer.
You know, there's real magic in Diet Pepsi. It's got that special aha ingredient. Aha! The right one, baby. Okay, girls. Now, what's that magic ingredient?
Uh-huh. With 100% uh-huh.
We move to the second quarter. UCLA on top of Fullerton, 6-0. And our UCLA quarter notes are being brought to you by Great Western. And here is the story. Luis Perez, 2 field goals, 43 and 37. Sean LaChapelle, 65 yards. Trendale Williams, the quarterback, 8 carries, 37 yards. Wayne Cook, by the way, 3 out of 5 for 65, all to Sean LaChapelle. And our stats being compiled by the best, Dennis Manishin and Jimmy Souders. And there's Kevin Williams hurtling out across the 35-yard line on second down. Stop made by John Haynes of Fullerton, who tripped him up.
Well, really, it's two great plays. And the first one's made by Wayne Cook, the quarterback. He's going down to the ground, and he makes a great pitch to Kevin Williams right here. Whoop! Right over the top. And Kevin, now that's really working right there. That's a gain of 4 or 5 yards.
That's that option we were talking about UCLA had to run to open things up, create some voids on this defense. Tough to run against this Washington-type defense. Not a lot of gaps. Third down. Play action. On the run. Cook complete. LaChapelle close to a first down. Got it with the second effort up to the 45-yard line. That's a great play by Sean LaChapelle. B.B. Hudson makes the stop. Had some help, but LaChapelle gets the first down.
Right there, what sells this play right here? Wayne Cook comes out, extended arms, a good fake to Kevin Williams.
Sideline
right
warning.
He found his favorite target again. Sean LaChapelle, and right here, a second effort by LaChapelle. A nice straight arm, shakes about three tacklers, and right there kind of gets his neck bent a little bit on the knee of the tackler, but he'll take a play off and be back.
Sean LaChapelle, the first Bruin since Burr Baldwin back in 1946 to lead the Pac-10 in receiving. He's been nursing a bit of a sore back all camp long. So the Bruins will keep a close eye on him. It'll be first down for UCLA at the 45.
Way to go.
James Milliner has now checked in at fullback for UCLA. Your impressions of Wayne Cook up to this point? Obviously, it's his debut for us.
Well, obviously, his numbers are pretty good so far. I think he's had a couple shaky plays, but for the most part, getting the ball to Sean LaChapelle has been a big positive for Wayne.
Pitch it to Williams. Cutting inside, not a lot of room. A yard at the most.
A gain of a yard.
I would say one of the biggest things, Bill, coming in again on Wayne Cook, I had asked Coach Homer Smith early on how much of the offense Wayne Cook would handle coming into this ballgame. He said all the weapons, the entire offense. And right there, that's a big positive for Wayne Cook coming in with all the arsenal.
Which was really a surprise to you. You didn't think he'd get the full plate to deal with, did you?
No, I didn't. And quite frankly, that means Wayne's done a great job of learning the offense and spending the necessary time.
Cook, who had 8 snaps all of last year, didn't throw a football, now under a rush. Scrambling for his life, got some yardage, crossed midfield into Fullerton territory. Pretty good game, making something out of nothing there. Thomas Kale, number 55 for Fullerton, runs him down. It'll be third down for UCLA with 13-18 remaining in the second.
Well, any quarterback that plays a position knows that mobility's part of the game. And Wayne right there really never getting a chance to get set up. And Big Joe Elizondo just chasing after him, and Wayne does the right thing, gains some yards, gets out of bounds.
And Big Joe Elizondo out of the College of the Desert, one of the players of the week last week for Fullerton. Rolling right once again, throwing. Cook complete this time to Michael Wynn, the sophomore. And that's a first down for UCLA. So Michael Wynn makes his first catch of the season, the thinking man's receiver. Knows all the nuances.
A gain of 4 yards.
I know they expected a lot out of Mike Wynn a year ago, and really he just never got up to form. He was nursing some injuries, and this fall camp, I know they expect a lot from him, and he has been dinged up a little bit, but Mike Wynn, a real sure-handed receiver.
What a story he is. His family escaped from Saigon by ship. He was born in Vietnam. Went to high school in Portland. Cook on first down. Plenty of time. Over the middle, wide open. The pass was a little late getting there. Thus, a great play by B.B. Hudson, the senior, and the fastest of the defensive backs. Fine play to come back and knock it away.
Well, a lot of it's just recognition. Right here, Wayne Cook, in a week, he'll make this throw. The pass took too long to deliver. Right there, his roommate, Rick Daly, down the middle of the field. He's wide open, but it just took too long to get him the ball.
Perfect timing also. Cook knows it.
He knows it.
Rick Daly, the tight end from Freedswood, Texas, was open. Second and 10, UCLA at the Fullerton 44. Bruins lead 6-0. Williams the tailback, Khalid Carter the fullback. Whoa, here comes the blitz. Down goes Cook. And they're going to whistle him down at the 44-yard line. Lorenzo Haley coming in a rush. The big play guy with the sack.
Well, no one even got a hat on Lorenzo Haley. He just picked the A gap right there and just beat Derek Stevens. Derek Stevens never saw him. He makes a play on Wayne Cook. And thankfully for UCLA, the ball spotted dead.
Loss of 7 yards.
Again, Lorenzo Haley just blowing right through the A gap, right up the middle of the offense. Kevin Williams, knowing the ball's dead, he didn't want to give chase.
Third and 17.
Kevin Jordan, J.J. Stokes, Sean LaChapelle in for UCLA. There is Haley. He was the leading Titan tackler back in 1990, coming back off of a redshirt year. Third and forever for UCLA, third and 17. Cook. Zings it complete to the 30-yard line, down at the 25. 27 yards. Sean LaChapelle, his fourth catch, fifth catch.
Well, just a really fine route, pass route again. Sean LaChapelle just really working his guys, getting zoned once again. And Kearney Johns, number 42, just kind of floating in midair out there. And LaChapelle just doing a fine job. And more importantly, Wayne Cook putting the ball right on the money.
Five catches, 101 yards for Sean LaChapelle. He has caught a ball in 24 straight games. On the option, pitch it to Williams. Leaps now gets outside to the 15, down to the 8-yard line. Kevin Williams turning it on, showing some speed. Darius Watson tripped him up there, 16 yards and another UCLA first down.
Well, Kevin Williams last year, to my disbelief, he never started a ball game for UCLA. Right here, Wayne Cook doing a nice job pressing the defensive end, but right here hurdling another would-be tackler. Kevin Williams, just shining star, and really just one of the huge big playmakers for UCLA last year and this year.
He became one of six Bruins to rush for 1,000 yards in a season last year. Kevin Williams always has had the talent, the attitude. He's always been getting dinged up a bit. Avery Anderson split to the left. LaChapelle to the right. Cook, give it straight up the middle. Kevin Williams reaches for the goal line. Is he in? No indication. They're going to mark him just short of the goal line. Lorenzo Haley, if he doesn't get a hand on Kevin Williams, it's 6 points for UCLA.
I think in the NFL, I believe in the NFL they give you this call because without instant replay, he makes a great play. Kevin Williams just really bursting for it. Well, maybe I'll take that back since he was dragging his knee at the three. That's where they spotted it.
A good call by the officials. Second down for UCLA.
I tried.
Cook over center. Cook. Loss it for LaChapelle. Incomplete. LaChapelle going at Darius Watson, the 6 foot junior out of Carson High School, and a good one. A true safety playing corner, but he had six interceptions last year to lead the Big West, and he went one-on-one with LaChapelle.
Well, you couldn't ask for a better throw of the ball. Wayne Cook, just a little fade route by Sean LaChapelle, put it right on the numbers. Sean, I'm sure, will dream about that one.
And say, I should have had it. J.J. Stokes to the left. Cook is 6 out of 10 for 106. All six completions have gone for first downs. This is third and goal. Kevin Williams trying to push it in. Touchdown, UCLA. Kevin Williams goes the last couple of yards for Terry Donahue's Bruins, and it's 12-0 with 10:37 remaining in the second quarter. Luis Perez on for the extra point.
right there. The offensive line doing a great job out there. Von Parker getting a nice block. Khalif Carter putting the helmet on somebody. And really, Kevin makes it look oh so easy with that great explosive speed he has.
Nice job by the front line of UCLA, which should be a good one this year. And of course, Khalif Carter, the heat-seeking missile at fullback. One of the best blocking fullbacks you'll see anywhere. Perez high snap, Clark gets it down again. So give Jeff Clark credit. Two times, he has saved a bad snap, and a flag is down. Perez was knocked down after the kick, and it might be Darius Watson getting penalized. That'll be a personal foul, roughing the kicker against Fullerton, and Perez is down.
Roughing the kicker against the Titans.
Well, as you said, Jeff Clark made a great catch in the snap. Goes high, and unfortunately, Darius Watson falling into him. It looks like he clipped an ankle.
And it would be the kicking ankle, too.
Definitely roughing the kicker.
And Perez is still down.
What
a huge loss that would be for UCLA if Perez was to miss any time at all, because what a find he was last year when Terry Donahue didn't know where his kicking game was going to come from. Out of Carson High School and El Camino College, Luis Perez had the two field goals in the entire UCLA offense in the Hancock Bowl versus Illinois. This will be assessed on the kickoff. And we will, of course, keep you appraised of Luis Perez when we come back. Going to take a quick break. Kevin Williams, touchdown maker, 13-0 Bruins.
There are a lot of different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Play your part.
Come to where the action is, the Normandy Casino. Enjoy an evening out at your total entertainment destination. Celebrate Mexican Independence Day with a mariachi show starring Olga Briskin and enjoy Southern Country Rock with a sleep at the wheel. Come to where the action is, the Normandy Casino, one block west of the Harbor Freeway on Rosecrans.
Nah, honey, pack up the kids. We're going to the Redondo Pier. Fun-filled and historic, the Redondo Beach Pier. Plenty of parking, where Torrance Boulevard meets the sea.
UCLA football is brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. And by Great Western's family of companies, $38 billion strong, Great Western will always be there. Bill McDonald, Tom Ramsey, welcome you back to the Rose Bowl. And there is Kevin Williams, 13-0. UCLA, a three-yard touchdown run around the right side for Williams to cap that drive for the Bruins. Gene Murphy's team staying close, staying tight, making some good plays defensively. But Tom Ramsey, you were looking at me during the break and saying, Kevin Williams, big time, he could have a big year.
Well, Kevin Williams, just, I mean, he's such a superb running back. I thought that a year ago. I really didn't believe what people were writing about him and saying about him. And he really has put all those people in their place, and he's done a fabulous job.
He has a sense of confidence this year. He's going to see about 70-75% of the snaps. Eric Wright boots it out of the end zone. You would hope he would. He got 15 yards on the penalty tacked on after Perez went down. And hopefully we'll get a report on Perez for you. He was off the field. And here's the scoring drive for UCLA. 13 plays, 68 yards, well executed. Mixing the pass and the run, topped off by Kevin Williams in that 3-yard jaunt around the right side.
And Wayne Cook, a big play, 3rd and 17, comes up with a big throw to Sean LaChapelle to keep that drive alive.
Trendell Williams still the quarterback. We should see a little of Quincy Guy, a 5'9 sophomore. Prop 48 performer. A little bit later on, very quick and exciting, but right now it's Trendell Williams, the 205-pound junior. Trendell still with the football. Bangs his way out across the 25-yard line. Mike Shalinski and Marvin Goodwin there for UCLA. Marvin Goodwin, of course, trying to take the place of Matt Darby, playing Darby's old position. Good look at Trendell. One problem last week, his offensive coordinator, Jim Chaney, said he was carrying the ball like a pizza man sometimes. He wants him to take care of it, and he certainly has for the most part this evening so far.
And Jim Chaney can't expound and give you some of those superlatives.
A lot of fun talking to him during the week. Second and four, just under 10 minutes to play, first half. Glad you're with us, 13-0 UCLA. Up the middle, Arthur Davis.
Hand off to Arthur Davis.
And Arthur Davis, minimal yardage. Bradley Craig. Nobody really came to the forefront in his linebacker position. He was in. Saleh Asaya, take a look at him, number 55, the nose guard. 6'4", 285, one of three true freshmen last year to letter for UCLA. There's Saleh.
Third and two from the 28.
It'll be third down and three for Cal State Fullerton.
Hey, look at that UCLA defense. They returned so many guys. It's incredible from a year ago. And really, Bradley Craig, a nice addition. And Jameer, of course, flipping sides over to the stud linebacker position.
Eddie Lua, Arthur Davis in the back. Pitch it to Arthur Davis. He's going to lose yardage. Down he goes. Nowhere to hide from Arnold Ollie. What pursuit? Ollie was joined by a lot of his teammates. Matt Werner, one of them.
Yeah, great pursuit. Arnold Ollie right here coming out, taking the pitch man. Jameer, of course, putting the pressure on Trendell Williams. And right here, Arnold's going to get a lot of help. The whole team pursuing just a sea of blue.
Arnold prefers the outside. He's basically playing the inside. His coaches seem to think that when he becomes a pro, he'll be playing inside. He might be a little undersized, but what a sensational talent. Noel Prefontaine again. Rushed this time by UCLA. La Chapelle has it at the 35. He might get some yards if he can turn the corner. Gains 10 as it is out to the 45. After a 45-yard kick by Noel Prefontaine, Kerry Johns makes the stop for the special teams for the Titans. And there's Noel out of Oceanside. Was the San Diego Union Tribune a North County Player of the Year in high school last season. They're quite high on him as a kicker. Phil Nevin, who signed the big contract with the Houston Astros, the great baseball star for Fullerton, did all the chores, both place kicking and punting for Fullerton the last 3 years, so they've had to find some guys quickly down at Fullerton. First down for UCLA. Devin Williams, Darren Washington in the backfield, straight drop. Looking off to his second receiver, Jordan, and it's knocked away. Good defensive play by Fullerton. It will be second down.
You know, Wayne Cook, that time he went from left to right to left, back to right. And Kevin Jordan looking for a nice window. He's really an outlet guy in this situation. He really needs to come back to the ball right there to help Cook out. I'm sure Coach Rick Neuheisel is going to get after him a little bit in the meeting room. But really, if he comes back to the ball, it's a completion.
B.B. Hudson, a returning starter at corner. Good play. Four wide receivers in this plant. Kevin Williams buries his head, gets out close to midfield. It'll still be third down for UCLA. Mike Allen, number 46, makes the stop, the defensive end for Fullerton. Perez took a helmet in the thigh, a bruise, should be back. So that's the report on Luis Perez, which is, of course, great news for UCLA. We have 8:21. Clock is moving here in the first half. UCLA leads Fullerton 13-0. Fullerton 1-0 on the year. UCLA, this is their first of the season. They will play at BYU next week in Provo. Cook winds, fires, has La Chapelle again. First down and more. Inside the 20. Down to the 12-yard line, Sean La Chapelle. 39 more yards. Cardell Avery, the safety, finally bringing down Sean La Chapelle. But he is really turning in those mid routes into big gainers, Tom Ramsey.
Well, when you lead the Pac-10 in receiving, obviously you get a lot of respect. And right there, they're playing off him. But the big mistake is Kearney Johns, 42, in the chase position again. Sean La Chapelle, I think, really surprising a lot of people with his speed and doing a fine job once again.
140 yards already for La Chapelle receiving. He made four catches in every game last year, did La Chapelle. You want to talk about a sensational season, that's exactly what Sean had. And G. Murphy says, you got to cover that guy. 7:41 remaining. First half. UCLA on the move again. We'll take a timeout. Stay with us.
It's very dependable, and I like the looks of it.
I have no problems with it. Knock on wood.
Car wash is about the biggest maintenance expense I have.
It's easy to maintain. It's easy to drive. I have to worry about it.
It starts, and I go, and it hasn't been any concern.
I like my Honda.
I love it. I wouldn't have any other car ever.
She liked me for my Honda. Can you believe that?
I've been pumping my own gas for years. Well, these days, you gotta look for every opportunity to save a few bucks. And when you open a regular checking account at Great Western Bank, that's what you'll do. Just keep $500 in your account and there's no charge. And you can do that. There's 8 ways to get free checking at Great Western.
Hey, buddy, fill it up.
You go call him. I gotta talk to this guy.
These are teachers. But to the kids they've reached, they're heroes. Be a teacher. Be a hero. Call 1-800-45-TEACH.
There's the story, and there is Sean LaChapelle. Let me reiterate a point I was making. LaChapelle made at least 4 receptions in every game last year. Here he's got 6 for 141.
Impressive so far tonight. Second quarter.
They're going to play him at every wide receiver position and even line him up at fullback at times to try to hide him. And they'll try to get him away from double teams. Right there, Kevin Williams just moving inside the 10. Cardell Avery there, along with Thomas Kale, big number 55, who's in there for Randy Strickland at the defensive line. And Kevin Williams getting a lot of work.
Second and 9.
Boy, Williams, what a big play guy. He had runs of 72, 57, 55, 49, and 45 yards last year. He can get it done.
72-yarder coming in the final Pac-10 game against USC.
And a 74-yarder on a screen pass versus Tennessee. Touchdown, UCLA! J.J. Stokes takes it from Wayne Cook. 10 yards in the score.
Well, J.J. Stokes really was the man that time, number 18. A big target for Wayne Cook, going about 6'4 and a half. And right there, Wayne Cook again trying to fade on the other side before he went to LaChapelle. This time, JJ making a fine catch. BB Hudson all over him. But JJ coming down with the ball, touchdown UCLA.
JJ Stokes, 6'4 plus. BB Hudson, 5'9. The mismatch and the touchdown. Luis Perez back on, drills it. So Perez adds the extra point, and it is 20-0 UCLA with 6:58 remaining in the half. J.J. Stokes, we're going to see this a lot this year, especially if LaChapelle gets double-teamed on the other side, and it's a mismatch with Stokes.
Exactly. And also what they've said about Wayne Cook, you know, he has a real gun for an arm, but also right there has a real nice touch getting the ball up and over the defender, although 5'9 isn't a big defender on Hudson's end, but J.J. once again going up nice for the ball and coming down with the first touchdown.
Out of Point Loma, and there is Wayne Cook from Newberry Park.
Right there, he's on the phones talking to Coach Homer Smith, and I'm sure Coach Smith is just telling him, Wayne, fine job. You're doing well. Keep the team moving. They just want to keep the machine well-oiled and just keep moving.
You know, it's interesting when I was talking to the coaches before, I said, tell me a little bit about Wayne Cook. And the coaches said, hey, unlike Tom Ramsey, he can really rip it. So,
oh, sure.
They're going to bag you at any opportunity, I'll tell you that.
Oh, yeah.
Arthur Davis back to return. The story, how Cook got to UCLA, is an interesting one. We'll tell you that a little bit later. Coming right at you on this kickoff. And it's a liner. You go in and through the end zone. Arthur Davis will just wave goodbye at it.
Ball goes into the end zone for a touchback.
And it will come out to the 20-yard line.
First and 10, Fullerton at the 20-yard line.
And we will see Quincy Guy now. There he is about to come into the ball game. So the Titans going to mix things up down 20 to nothing here in the first half. Quincy Guy, the 5'9", 180-pound sophomore, would be a starting cornerback if they didn't have him at quarterback. Probably Fullerton's best athlete. He had four carries for 55 yards. One was a 33-yard, and he really turned something into nothing on that play, Tom.
Well, he really did. I had joked with Coach Jim Cheney before the game. Quincy actually went the wrong way. And Coach Cheney said, well, he had about seven minuses for the play, but he ended up scoring. So it was a good job from the coach.
That time, Matt Werner wraps him up after a gain of about one. UCLA on the scoring drive. Cook to Stokes, caps it off. Five plays, 55 yards. Bam, getting it done like UCLA last year did in a minute 56. And Wayne Cook's debut so far, A's across the board.
Absolutely. He's really his star shining tonight. We have a full moon tonight also. And Wolves are out a little bit, but Wayne Cook doing a fine job and really having a nice control of the offense. They've mixed in the run and pass. And LaChapelle, of course, making big plays along the way.
These first three games for UCLA really will set the tone for their conference season, which does not include Washington on the schedule once again this year. So when the people are looking at UCLA's schedule, they're saying, hey, it's favorable. But next week, going to be a chore. If anybody saw that game Thursday night, San Diego State and BYU, those teams can light it up, and those two are the next Bruin opponents. And Quincy Guy will get a quick lecture over here at the sidelines. And we were just speaking of it. Next up for the Bruins, one of college football's most explosive teams, BYU, on the schedule for UCLA. Tom and I will be there to bring you all the action next Monday. Now check it, next Sunday at 10:30, right here on Prime Ticket. So Sunday night, it will be BYU and UCLA. Eric Drage, of course, throwing wild. John Walsh impressed me, throwing the football too with his mobility and his composure in the pocket.
Yeah, John Walsh did a fine job, and Drage is really an unbelievable receiver. He reminds me a little bit of LaChapelle, kind of a stretch kind of guy, I want to say, lanky, but Drage just comes down with balls he has no business catching, but doing a great job for BYU.
Here comes Fullerton at the 20-yard line, second and nine, call it the 21. Quincy Guy over center. Eric Gamble's his fullback, Arthur Davis also in the backfield. Guy looks like he wants to throw. Now aborts quickly and gets out to about the 23-yard line. Nikosi Littleton,
Matt Werner on the tackle,
who was hampered much of the year last season with an ankle problem, halts Quincy Guy.
Again, 2 yards.
And Quincy Guy, really, he's been hampered by a hamstring injury throughout the preseason. And again, Coach Jim Cheney really didn't tell us that Quincy Guy was going full throttle. He may step it out tonight and go full throttle against the Bruins.
One way to turn Quincy Guy, slippery. Third and seven. Let's see if he puts it up. 20 to nothing UCLA. Throwing to the left. He's going to have to throw it if he wants that first down. Down he goes at the 22-yard line. And once again, Nikosi Littleton showing some great speed, running down Quincy Guy, who's a quick one. So Nikosi Littleton playing a position of concern for the UCLA defense. Brings down the quarterback.
Well, again, number 23, Donnie Edwards, applying the pressure, making Guy go out and around. And right there, he's not going to throw the ball. And you see just the flash come out of nowhere. Littleton making a big play.
Brian Ty showing some good pursuit, helping out Littleton. 4:54 remaining in the half, 20-0 UCLA. Prefontaine to LaChapelle, who returned six punts last year towards the end of the season. He's going left, and he's going down. 53-yard punt, 4-yard return for Sean LaChapelle. Going to take a break. Be right back. Bruins in charge.
It's Chevy Rock Solid Value Days. Now get low 2.9% GMAC financing on Chevy CK pickup. Rank the best full-size pickup by J.D. Power & Associates initial quality study. At 2.9%, you'll save nearly $3,000 in finance charges on a new Chevy CK. Only during Rock Solid Value Days. The trucks you can depend on. at Trucks That Last.
Get the number one selling full-size truck in Southern California at your Southern California Chevrolet dealer now.
For the last time, name the secret ingredient that gives Diet Pepsi an unfair advantage.
Uh-huh.
Well, what is it?
It's like this, baby. You know it's uh-huh, because the taste says uh-huh, baby.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
You got the right one, baby.
With 100% uh-huh. If you've discovered that suddenly you could use a little more room, discover just how much more room there is in the all-new 1993 Toyota Corolla. And discover Corolla again.
That is youthful enthusiasm right there. UCLA leading 20 to nothing, and just part of the festivities. And we are located right up in there, part of this brand new complex, this Press Box Executive Suite complex, which is absolutely sensational here at the Rose Bowl. Really added a lot of years to the life of this stadium. Ricky Davis now in at the tailback position, and he's going to get a chance. Up the middle he goes across the 40-yard line. So a big hole up the middle for Ricky Davis. Al Witten now in the ball game. He's nursing a sore hamstring, but he's in there playing now. But Ricky Davis bursts up the middle for a first down.
Well, Ricky Davis, really, who fought for playing time last year and started a few games, and right there just bursting up the middle. You see the line doing, again, doing a great job. Rick Fuller now in at right tackle. See big number 70. And, of course, Darren Washington, number 30, in there helping Ricky Davis out.
That fullback position, we're going to see a lot of bodies in there. First down for Cook at the 40-yard line. 4:15 remaining in the half. Now the protection breaks down, and down he goes at the 36-yard line. Randy Strickland with the sack from Compton High School and El Camino JCs. Strickland, 6'1", 285 on a slim day, and a senior.
Well, look for Rob Walker to start warming up right there. Wayne Cook, really, I think he did something to his knee that time. He's having a tough time, and what other way to get Bruin fans excited but warm up the number two quarterback who's never taken a snap either.
There is an urgency at UCLA to develop the backup quarterback. That we will say. Because when your number one guy hasn't taken a snap, you realize the guys below certainly don't have any experience either. In fact, Wayne Cook last year, you got to remember, he was the number three guy. So he really didn't get a lot of work last year.
That's right. Jimmy Bonds, the number two guy. And Jimmy Bonds had a great year a year ago filling in for Tommy Maddox. And I know Jimmy wishes he had another year, but right there he's supporting Wayne. And you're going to see right there big Randy Strickland, number 98, falling on it. That doesn't feel good.
And up 20 to nothing here in the first half. Good numbers for Wayne Cook, but if there is a question at all, you get him out of there. And there is Rob Walker, a lot of the same similar talents as Wayne Cook, the redshirt freshman.
Yeah, I think if there's any game, you let the number two guy come in and start doing a job for you. Even though it's the opening game, Rob Walker, 6'3", redshirt freshman out of Austin, Texas. This is the game against Cal State Fullerton. You're going to see some looks, and you're going to see Cal State Fullerton start sending some people now. They're going to be blitzing. Kirk Harmon, the defensive coordinator, knows that Wayne had some recognition factors, and now, hey, let's test the number two guy.
That's what they have to do, send everything at you with the blitz packages.
I was going to say, Wayne Cook has had a knee injury before coming out of high school, before he went into UCLA. He suffered a knee injury, and that set him back, in fact, his first year at UCLA. But what ended up happening, he knows what those knee injuries feel like. Rob Walker given the chance.
Rob Walker inherits a second down and 14 for UCLA at the Bruin 37-yard line. Bruins up 20 to nothing first half. Walker give it on the delay, not much room. Squirming out is Ricky Davis. Randy Strickland once again makes the stop. Ricky Davis. And there's a penalty. A marker down at the 40-yard line of Fullerton. And we might have a hold in the defensive backfield. Personal foul, no, it's gonna be on UCLA. So the Bruins destructing on this drive. And this will set back UCLA even further. So Wayne Cook goes out with a knee or ankle injury. Rob Walker now in the contest. Also of interest, dead Jonathan ball. Ogden in.
Personal foul, offense. Still be third down.
Boy, this is third down and forever. If I said it before, this truly is, as they need to get to the 49 of Fullerton for a first down, and Walker will have the ball at the 23-yard line.
Well, Jonathan Ogden, all of 6'8", about 325 pounds. Coach Jim Herrick of the basketball team just walked in. I think he could use someone about that big and that hefty.
He could use somebody in the four spot.
Third and 29.
Third down. See if Walker puts it up. No, he pitches the ball. Davis cuts inside, has some room, and he's brought down at the 30-yard line. Gain of 7, but far short of the first down. And Lorenzo Haley, who's had a pretty productive first half, brings him down there, and the Bruins will punt. First punt of the night for Terry Donahue's guys, and Aaron Shager will be on. Shager, the 5'11", 198-pound junior. Napoleon Poli Banks is back to receive this kick. Shager beat out Courtney Kyler for the punting chores. 24-yard line. Banks scoots up the middle. Spun down at the 36-yard line. 46-yard boot, 12-yard return. Othello Henderson gets it done on special teams, bringing him down for UCLA. And there is Napoleon Banks, 5'8", 170, and a junior. Last week brought one back 24 yards, so that one was a 12-yard return. And Fullerton in business again with 2.5 to play here in the first half, but they're down 20-0. And you look back at a turning point in this quarter, it's when Fullerton and Trendell Williams were driving early in that first quarter and fumbled inside UCLA territory. They haven't really threatened since. Quincy Guy. Pitch it now to Jermaine Hill with some room. Bears his head. He's loose. Jermaine Hill down to the 29-yard line. Carlton Gray finally with the stop at the 5'8 sophomore, known for his excellent blocking, rumbles 35 yards and a Titan first down.
It's a problem you face in any opening day game. You don't know how your tackling's going to be. And Coach Bob Field right here, some concern. A lot of arm tackles by the Bruins, and Jermaine Hill just really running right through it. Saleh Asaya had him wrapped up, and he just keeps on running. Whoa. Jason Green finally, number 91, bringing him down.
Jermaine Hill last week, one carry, lost 3 yards. How do you do? Gains 35. Guy, bad decision that time, hesitated and lost. Matt Werner got a handful of Quincy Guy, an armful of him, and down went the quarterback. Matt Werner, extremely active, one of UCLA's best pass rushers. He is so quick. You know, he started last year filling in for Brian Kelly, but wound up splitting time with him.
Absolutely. I was going to say Matt Werner was probably one of the standout defensive linemen a year ago, and he really didn't get near the accolades nor the playing time he probably should have, but this year he's going to get more than enough playing time.
Fullerton, second down. The Titans, second and 11. Guy keeps it again, wants to go the other way. Can't skip outside, and he's down at the 30-yard line. Saleh Asaya with the tackle. Quincy Guy likes to keep that football, doesn't he?
Well, Quincy Guy, it's interesting. The play before, Bill, you said he had hesitated also. I think this is part of his makeup, is that when he's running the option, he likes to let the defense over-pursue. Therefore, he's cutting back against the grain, and really, as a true running back, running to daylight, more or less, he's trying to reverse field, and a lot of times, well, at least that time, UCLA's defense had a nice pursuit angle on him.
Third down. 51 seconds remaining first half. Guy drops back, throws, got a man, complete. Down to the 17-yard line. Frank Davis, the senior, transfer from Grossmont JC. 13 yards and a Fullerton first down. The coverage there by the All-American, Carlton Gray.
Well, Frank Davis, a year ago for Cal State Fullerton, he actually had some big numbers for him. And when I say big numbers, I mean 10 catches, but he was going to be a featured guy this year, but they went ahead, got rid of their passing game offense, all of a sudden became an option team overnight. And of course, Frank's not getting a lot of receptions, but making a big one there.
Yeah, no catches last week, so that's his first of the season. On first down, Quincy Guy will keep it up, and there he goes! He's going to score. Touchdown, Fullerton. Quincy Guy, 16 yards. And the Titan faithful whooping it up. 20 seconds remaining in the first half. And Fullerton, a nice drive, and they're on the board.
Well, it's a nice little wrinkle put in by Jim Chaney, a little reverse out. Once again, Quincy Guy just using his athleticism, just bursting up the middle and just outrunning the UCLA defense, who really seemed to be caught off guard with the reverse out that he took. Nice play by Quincy Guy.
So the Bruins stunned Julio Ocana. Another left-footed kicker on and gets the extra point. Ocana, born in Panama City, Panama, the 6-foot junior, boots it through, but the hero right now, right there, Quincy Guy. 16 yards bursting up the middle.
It's a real nice shot. You're going to see the linemen. You see a lot of twisting, a lot of cross-blocking up front by the Fullerton linemen. And the hole looks huge, and granted it is, but just for a split second, Quincy Guy using his speed and explosiveness and really get through the hole.
At halftime, and that's just a few moments away, we will send you back to the studio of Prime Ticket. Glenn Walker and College Football Today, scores and highlights of all the action in college football. So that's coming up at halftime in just a few moments. Fullerton on the board, it's 20-7 UCLA. And Gene Murphy has seen success in his tenure at Fullerton. Oh, has he? He won the conference championship in 83. In 84, his team went 11-1, made the top 20. In fact, he finished second in 85, 87, 88, 89. And then the money ran out. And he has high hopes for this team. Last year, he finished beating Long Beach State by a point. No truth to the matter that that win caused Long Beach to drop the program, he says. But they ended last year with only 43 players on the team, and they welcomed over 100 to camp this year. So it's really on the mend, that program. Ricky Davis was back, but it's taken by the short man, and he's drilled at the 27-yard line. Penn Fullerton fired up going into the locker room. That's for sure, 16 seconds remaining. So Quincy Guy comes on to direct the drive for the Titans.
You mentioned Coach Gene Murphy. It really is a tribute to him. He really has been the guy to spearhead it, keep the program moving along, and really devoted so much time and effort into seeing Fullerton a success. And granted, the reason they had 100 players coming into camp, Long Beach State, of course, dropping their program.
Rob Walker. And, of course, Wayne Cook injured. Walker over the middle, incomplete. And Ricky Davis is down and hurt, and there's a flag. We might get a taunting penalty, actually, on Fullerton. Davis was drilled after the ball sailed over his head, and then a couple of Fullerton players, possibly Al Witten, stood over Ricky Davis, a la Muhammad Ali over Sonny Liston a few years back.
I was waiting for the Allah.
I know, Allah. I was dancing around the Allah.
I have to say, I don't want to say it's the fault of a young quarterback, but Rob Walker really putting the ball down the field late is not a place where you want to be going with the ball.
15 yards from the previous spot.
And it was unsportsmanlike conduct, which I'm sure was the taunting call, Bill, an accurate call. And right there, Rob Walker, he's standing there just taking far too long to deliver the ball down the middle. Actually, it's PI as well. I mean, he hit him far.
There's the penalty right there. The hit was okay.
Well, I think it was before the ball even came into being, but right there, well, that the shenanigans go on here.
That's going to get you 15. And there's Al Witten from Modesto JC. Although he's labeled as a big hitter in the secondary, he really leveled Davis, but then he stood over him, and that will probably burn a few personalities on UCLA too. They'll have that number 26 ingrained, thinking about him a little later on, and that's why Davis is saying something. 10 seconds remaining in the half. This gives the Bruins a possible chance now to get some field position. We have a report on Wayne Cook. Sprained knee, doubtful for the rest of the game. So we will probably not see Cook. It's a sprained knee. Walker's got some room. Slides down at the 46, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and that'll be it. The half is over. And Cal State Fullerton, pretty darn good first half for the Titans. They come into the Rose Bowl not in awe. But UCLA still with the advantage at the half, 20-7 over Fullerton. We'll be back to discuss the first half, but first stay tuned for the College Football Today wrap-up with Glenn Walker right after this. Don't move.
Today in California, 350,000 people improve their inner selves. 3 million improve their outer ones. The Karuk Tribe Health Center got a Pacific Bell-centric system and a promise to maintain it at no extra cost for life. Jeff Thompson got his lawn painted. It's just another day in California. Tomorrow will be better.
It's Chevy Rock Solid Value Days. Now get low 2.9% GMAC financing on Chevy CK pickup. Rank the best full-size pickup by J.D. Power & Associates initial quality study. At 2.9%, you'll save nearly $3,000 in finance charges on a new Chevy CK. Only during Rock Solid Value Days. The trucks you can depend on. The trucks that last.
Get the number one selling full-size truck in Southern California at your Southern California Chevrolet dealer now.
Hi, honey. What brings you to my office?
My car broke down again.
That does it. This time, we're going to Martin Chevrolet. Your mom and I have been coming to Martin for years, and they've always treated us like family.
Come to Martin Chevrolet Geo, serving South Bay family since 1967. Located on Hawthorne Boulevard, a few blocks north of PCH in Torrance.
Thanks, Dad. You were right. Martin Chevrolet does treat us like family.
That'll be $62.75.
Do you take plastic?
Plastic. Master Plaster!
Ching!
The recover car.
Ching!
Ultimate expense.
Gold!
Ching!
Platinum!
Ching!
Ching!
Uranium!
Ching!
Uranium?
Rallies still accepts cash. And very little of it. Rallies has it right.
This is Glenn Walker in the College Football Today studios. We hope you're enjoying the UCLA game against the Cal State Fullerton Titans. Right now, though, let's check out the rest of today's Pac-10 action. Beginning at Husky Stadium in Seattle, where the second-ranked Washington Huskies hosted the Badgers of Wisconsin this afternoon. Husky Stadium, first quarter, no score. Second play of the Husky drive, Billy Joe Hobart back to pass, finds Joe Qualick in the back of the end zone for a 17-yard connection, 7-0 Washington with the extra point. Next series for the Badgers, Jay Messias finds Tim Ware across the middle, and he will beat Walter Bailey into the end zone to tie the score at 7. But that was not going to be near enough for the Badgers today. As the number two team in the country, the Huskies come up with a 27-10 victory. Billy Joe Hobart was 17 of 29 for 185 yards and one touchdown. He also ran one in from 60 yards out. Napoleon Kaufman was held to only 43 yards on 7 carries for the Huskies and was ejected in the third quarter for arguing a call. Wisconsin only had 9 first downs in the game as the Huskies come up with their second victory of the season against no losses. Both the Oregon Ducks and the Stanford Cardinal open their Pac-10 schedules coming off season-opening losses. The Ducks suffered 5 turnovers losing to Hawaii, while the Cardinal opened the second Bill Walsh era losing to Texas A&M in the Pigskin Classic. Let's go to the farm and check out the action today. Walsh's first appearance back on the Stanford sidelines. On the home field, he didn't like what he saw early. Second quarter, Stanford up 3-0. Danny O'Neill, the play action to Derek Deadweiler in the corner. That put the Ducks up 7-0. But the Cardinals would come back behind the explosive Glenn Milburn. He takes the handoff, busts up the middle, takes it to the outside, and he rambles 68 yards for the touchdown. And Stanford comes back to win it over the Oregon Ducks. Final score of 21-7. Milburn also caught a touchdown pass from Steve Stenstrom, who threw for over 353 yards today. That was a career high. The 17th-ranked Cal Bears were in West Lafayette to take on the Purdue Boilermakers, and the Boilermakers were all charged up for the Bears. Early on for Cal, Damian Seaman can't hold on to the ball after the screen pass, and Purdue would recover the cough-up and would steamroll from there. Purdue leading 10-0. Earl Coleman takes the Matt Pike's handoff, goes 11 yards in for the score, and Purdue was pouring it on. Later on, Pike will go upstairs, and he will hit Jeff Hill on the quick out for 6. The Bears get their bell rung this afternoon. The final score in a surprising shocker, 41-14 the final. Russell White was held to just 79 yards rushing as the Bears committed four turnovers while the Boilermakers scored on their first six possessions. And the game seen earlier here on Prime Ticket, the Washington State Cougars surviving the desert heat and the Wildcats of Arizona in Tucson at Arizona Stadium. Let's take a look at the highlights in that one. Wilbur the Wildcat getting buffed up early to face the gunslinger Drew Bledsoe, considered one of the finest quarterbacks in the country. Third quarter, Cats up 17-6, but Bledsoe would bring him back. Here he finds Deron Pointer on the up pattern. Great throw, great catch. Cats lead it, or cut the lead to 17-13. Fourth quarter now, Cats leading 20-13, and Bledsoe does it again. This time he finds Philip Bobo. Another great toss, another great catch, and the game is tied at 20. Less than a minute to go in the game, still tied at 20. Aaron Price, son of the coach Mike, drills the field goal from 47 yards out, and the Cougars survive the heat and the Wildcats in Tucson. The final score was 23-20. The Cougars now 2-0 on the season. The Wildcats drop to 1-1. A big intersectional game, third-ranked Notre Dame against sixth-ranked Michigan, always a traditional game early in the season. And first quarter, Reggie Brooks takes the pitch from Rick Meyer, breaks a few tackles, and then watch him hit the goal line. He is literally unconscious as he falls into the end zone for the touchdown. Irish led it 7-0. Now to the fourth, 10-7 Michigan. Elvis Gerbach already with one touchdown pass. He's looking for another. Derek Alexander wide open. He takes it in. Michigan led it 17-7 early in the fourth, but Notre Dame marched 65 yards to the Michigan 2, and Jerome Bettis punched it in from there. The Irish later added a field goal to tie the game at 17. Final minute, Wolverines with the ball. Gerbach is picked off by Brian Radigan. No Michigan receiver in sight. Time runs out in South Bend, and they finish today in a sister kisser. But the final score was 17-17. Gerbach, two touchdown passes, but three interceptions. Rick Meyer, also a Heisman candidate, no interceptions today, but he also threw no touchdown passes. And stay tuned, the second half of UCLA, Cal State Fullerton from the Rose Bowl. Bill McDonald and Tom Ramsey are ready to bring you all the action. Enjoy the rest of the game, everybody.
Slowing down, that ain't you. No, no, that's not you. Easy drinking beer, that silver bullet smooth.
Know where it's coming from, setting the mood, the pure taste of the Rockies and silver.
Make the move, Coors Lights. Silver bullets move.
I think that the engines on Hondas are great.
Luxury, sporty, reliable, cheap. I mean, you can't beat that.
Got a terrific deal, but it would be worth even if I had to pay a little more for it.
It's probably about the most reliable car I've had. Is this on tape?
I never do anything crazy because I'm a lawyer.
I love my Honda. It's so reliable. Nothing has ever happened to my Honda.
Californians who shared a Wells Fargo coach shared something else.
I don't want to go.
They were treated as valued customers, but also as friends. Henry Wells said it best. There is one very powerful business rule, courtesy.
How about if I let you ride up top with me?
Can I, Mommy?
That's still how we do business in every Wells Fargo office.
Gracias.
Yes, ma'am.
It's a better brand of service. Welcome aboard.
If you could look into the future of your car, you'd do something about it. You'd pour in a one-time engine treatment of T-Plus with DuPont Teflon to protect your engine for as long as 50,000 miles so it would run smoother, last longer. If you use T-Plus, you might not worry about getting a new car. You might still have one. New car or old, get the T-Plus treatment. The T is for Teflon. The Plus is for protection.
It is halftime at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. We are live. UCLA football on Prime Ticket. And at the half, the Bruins on top of the Titans of Fullerton by the score of 20-7.
And welcome back, everybody. Bill McDonald along with Tom Ramsey. Let's get into that first half. First of all, for Fullerton, I thought they played pretty well, obviously, being able to stay with UCLA. They had a couple of good drives, the one in the first quarter led by Trendell Williams. He laid one down on the turf, and they botched that one up. But then Quincy Guy came back with authority.
Well, without a doubt, Fullerton came to play tonight. Coach Gene Murphy really got his troops fired up, and we really saw a spark when Quincy Guy came into the ball game. They had a big play by Jermaine Hill, broke off a big run, and of course Quincy Guy going over for six.
And for Fullerton, it's obviously a make or break defense. They'll make some big plays. We saw a couple of sacks and some big knockaways, but also they are susceptible to big plays going the other way.
Absolutely. They're playing that real pressure, eight-man front type defense, and UCLA taking advantage of it.
Wayne Cook played well before he got injured.
Yeah, he really did. It's a shame for Wayne Cook. He was really coming out. He might have made one bad throw early on, but he really came out and did a fine job leading the team, getting the ball to Sean LaChapelle. Really, the end of some big plays. He got the ball to J.J. Stokes one time for touchdown as well.
Let's get to LaChapelle in a minute, but right now, let's take a look at the injury to Wayne Cook. It is a sprained knee, and it happened towards the end of this play, Tom.
Yeah, real unfortunate. Number 98, Randy Strickland, is going to come from his tackle position right there. You see him, and it's really towards the end of the play, just as Wayne's getting hit to the ground. And, you know, something, those knee injuries, you never know. You hear something pop, and of course, Wayne Cook has had a knee injury, a previous knee injury, and I think the best thing, they're going to keep him out of the rest of the game and give Rob Walker a chance.
Cook, 8 out of 13, 155 yards and a touchdown before he went out. What does it mean now? Obviously, Cook cannot perform. This was going to be a good learning experience for him. He did get almost a half in, but now a chance for Rob Walker.
Well, I think Rob Walker, if there's any game this season that will enable him to be a better player and to play throughout the season, it's to play at Cal State Fullerton the first game of the season and not to come in the 11th game against USC in the fourth quarter when something's really on the line. It's early on.
LaChapelle, 6 catches, 141 yards. Kevin Williams, 13 carries and a touchdown. He looked good.
Well, Kevin Williams, I think, is just a fabulous player. He was a year ago and still is continuing to be that, just really blossoming into one of the premier running backs of the nation.
So it is 20-7, UCLA over Fullerton here at the half. And somebody is dearly missed here tonight in the press box. And for John Riebensdorf, this was to be his dream game. John Riebensdorf was the broadcaster for Cal State Fullerton for 10 years, for UCLA for 2 years. John passed away suddenly last month. This was to be his dream game. We dedicate this game and the season to the memory of John Riebensdorf, a Bruin and a Titan forever.
What?
Can't you see I'm busy? Ask your dad.
Ask your mother.
We'll discuss it later, dear.
What a question. Did you ask your mom?
Like, what an out there question.
Come on.
You sure do ask a lot of questions.
Don't ask! Run! Catch the ball!
What? Well, that's a really good question. Come on.
UCLA. People who ask outrageous questions find the answers for us all.
No!
Sometimes it is so exciting,
sit,
so magical, it doesn't even seem real.
Cut!
But it is real. It's UCLA football, and it happens at the Rose Bowl. Call UCLA 101 for the spectacular 6-game home schedule and ticket information.
Sports sedan is supposed to do well in the fast lane. But what about these lanes? At Lexus, we've achieved extremely tight tolerances between all major body panels. So not only does the ES300 look like it's put together well, it actually is put together well.
You know, Diet Pepsi's now for everyone.
That's right, Ray. Meet my twin brother, Herb.
And our twin, Herbettes.
With caffeine-free Diet Pepsi, I get all that great taste, but there's no caffeine. Sing it, brother.
You got the right one, baby. If it's irresistibly sippable, uncontestably tasteable, and caffeine-free, you got the right one, baby.
He's 100% uh-huh.
Halftime continues. First time these two have ever met on the football field. Bruins on top of the Titans, 20-7. We are live at the Rose Bowl. And just take a look. This is the brand new complex, the Press Box Executive Suite Complex. Three levels. That first level, all executive suites. If you've got $20,000 and you want to have a good seat for a football game, a wet bar and all the amenities, that's where you sit. The working press is in level number two. It can accommodate over 350. And trust me, those guys have never had it so good. And then we are up here. Level three, right at the 50-yard line. There's some more suites up here also. This is a great place to be, isn't it?
Well, it really is. I played the lotto tonight. I haven't got the winning numbers yet, but if I do hit it, I think I'll buy one of those suites.
You said this might be like the Ritz-Carlton of all the press boxes.
Oh, it is the Ritz-Carlton compared to what we did. We're here in before, the Motel 8, but it is awfully nice.
Before we get to the highlights, how's UCLA handling this option offense by Fullerton, do you think?
Well, I think UCLA's defense really has looked forward to facing an option offense. They know they're going to get a lot of runs. UCLA can really sink in and really attack the offense. And we've seen Jameer Miller, Arnold Allais, and Nkosi Littleton really come to the forefront. They're putting a lot of hats on people.
By the way, that is Nkosi. We were saying Nkosi, and you got me right there. Let's look at the highlights of the first half of action for UCLA. Their first couple of scores, of course, were Luis Perez field goals. UCLA, you know, they bogged down a couple of times in their first couple of drives, but they did get that ball laid down by Fullerton, that one time by Trendell Williams. But they were able to come back and get 6 points by Luis Perez. I think we're going to look at the stats right here. We're going to look at the first half statistics and the highlights. Let's first of all look at the stats right now. We're getting it all together here on opening night, and here are the field goals by Luis Perez. That's enough vamping by me.
That's right. Luis Perez, a 43-yarder that time, a nice hold by Jeff Clark, and Luis started it off scoring for the Bruins. Again, they go up 6-0 here with a 37-yarder.
6-0 UCLA. Then Shaw LaChapelle. We mentioned that he had a big first half. He brought the Bruins in to touchdown territory, capped off by Kevin Williams.
That's right. Shaw LaChapelle right here moving against air once again. And Wayne Cook putting the ball right on his numbers, and LaChapelle right there doing a great job taking it in the red zone territory down to the 10-yard line.
J.J. Stokes got a touchdown on the mismatch.
J.J. Stokes, all about 6'5", going over 5'9". B.B. Hudson right here. Quincy Guy, little reverse out, triple option, and he just takes it right up the heart of the UCLA defense for a score.
Those are the first half highlights. We knew we'd get them for you. Here are the stats, Tom Ramsey.
Well, the stats, you see the Bruins doubling the amount of first downs, lacking in rushing yards. Wayne Cook having a fine day. So far, total yards goes to the Bruins and the one turnover, of course, to the Titans.
I think the key here is Fullerton is not in awe. Yes, they're looking forward to coming into the Rose Bowl. It's been a lifelong dream for Gene Murphy not only to play here but to bring a team here. He's finally getting a chance to bring Fullerton in. But Fullerton has played in places. They played in Georgia last year. They played in Florida a couple years back. LSU, they can play with the big guys. We're going to be back with more. It's halftime, 20-7 UCLA. Stay with us.
There are a lot of different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Play your part.
Dad, do you have a minute?
Hi, honey. What brings you to my office?
My car broke down again.
That does it. This time, we're going to Martin Chevrolet. Your mom and I have been coming to Martin for years, and they've always treated us like family.
Come to Martin Chevrolet Geo, serving South Bay family since 1967. Located on Hawthorne Boulevard, a few blocks north of PCH in Torrance.
Thanks, Dad. You were right. Martin Chevrolet does treat us like family.
There's an old-fashioned bakery just around the corner, where you'll find the highest quality of baked goods that taste as good as they look, and a staff of friendly professionals dedicated to serve you. Where? At Torrance Bakery, of course.
From the traditional to the abstract, we have a large display of wedding cakes in our wedding cake showroom.
Torrance Bakery, an old-fashioned, friendly, full-service bakery in historic downtown Torrance. Treat yourself or someone special. You'll be glad you did.
Thank you.
range of the Lexus coupe was designed to exhilarate you. Even when you're not moving.
Back at the Rose Bowl, we are live tonight on Prime Ticket. Bill McDonald and Tom Ramsey, both teams back on the field, getting ready for half number two, 20-7, UCLA. And throughout the year, if some Bruins make the news, no matter what the sport, we're gonna give it to you. And right now, Jimmy Connors, ex-Bruin, in the news. Well, he didn't do so well this year in the U.S. Open, but old Jimbo going up against Martina for all the dough, Tom Ramsey.
That's right. Jimmy Connors did win the NCAAs his freshman year at UCLA, going against Martina Navratilova in the Battle of Champions at Caesars Palace, and that'll be on pay-per-view. Don't miss it.
I don't care what the rules are. I'm taking Jimmy. There you go. You got my pick. And there is Rob Walker, who will be the Bruin pick for the quarterback in the second half. If you've just joined us, Wayne Cook started the game, played pretty well, but sprained a knee late in the second quarter, will not return. That is the word. So Rob Walker getting some work, the freshman from Austin, Texas, 6'3", 198. Now the book on Walker, he's a gamer. Doesn't look that good in practice, but you put him out on the field and he performs.
Well,
that's what we hear.
I like that because I don't think I think I was a gamer as well. I think a lot of players consider themselves gamers because they screw up in practice and they go, but coach, just put me in the game and I'm a gamer, I promise you. And that's great to hear. Rob Walker did do a fine job. He came in a tough situation. At least he had a halftime to go over some things, and I'm sure Coach Homer Smith is going to give him some nice arsenal to work with.
We were talking tennis, and if you've gotten excited over the U.S. Open and some great matches today, then get ready for more. It's Andre Agassi versus John McEnroe live from the Great Western Forum Friday at 8. We'll be courtside to bring you all the action. McEnroe, Agassi, say no more, live Friday at 8 o'clock right here on Prime Ticket. Terry Donahue was worried about this one. He's ahead 20-7. But Fullerton, with a little momentum coming into half number two. Quincy Guy running it in from 16 yards with under a minute to play in that first half, and it is 20-7. And it's bobbled by the short man and just covered up at the 20-yard line. So UCLA will have the football to start the second half. And Carrick O'Quinn, the man on the ball. And Rob Walker will set up shop at the 20-yard line.
Oh, Carrick O'Quinn, the linebacker, not accustomed to handling the football, but he won't pass up the chance.
UCLA ranked number 16 this week. And here is Rob Walker without a huddle to start things off. Kevin Williams, Khalif Carter in the backfield. La Chapelle, Michael Wynn. Kevin Jordan also in for UCLA. Give it up the middle. Big hit going nowhere. Kevin Williams, Joe Elizondo. Story on Joe. He always wanted to go to Fullerton. His dad wanted him to go to Long Beach State and play for George Allen. So where did he go? Long Beach State. They dropped football. He's back at Fullerton.
Well, Joe Elizondo right there, a big cog in that Fullerton defense. And he puts a real helmet on Kevin Williams right there. Just a one-on-one tackle. Fine job by Big Joe.
Big series here for Fullerton. They've got to stop UCLA. Don't allow any points. They're down 27. It'd be a great way to start this half. There is Darren Washington. A look at the sophomore from Killeen, Texas. Darren's going to be playing some fullback and some tailback this year. Mostly playing in Sean Wills' pass-catching fullback position.
That's a good point. Sean Wills was such an integral part of the offense a year ago. Third down, Sean Wills would come in and really had great hands coming out of the backfield. Really, that's a tribute to be able to fill some shoes such as big as those.
Stokes, Wynn, and La Chapelle, the wideouts, on third down. We're a minute into the second half. Throw caught at the 32. No, incomplete. Dropped. J.J. Stokes had it, dropped it. Throw was a little low and Stokes couldn't hold on. And it will be fourth down in a punting situation, and the Titans right out of the chute here in the second half have held UCLA.
I sense there's a little nervousness on the UCLA sidelines. You really come into the game, Wayne Cook hasn't played, and then all of a sudden Rob Walker thrust into the position, a third down throw like that. It was a fine throw by Walker.
Holy Banks fumble, picks it up, down he goes at the 28-yard line. Othello Henderson His second fine play on the punt coverage team. 43-yard boot, 7-yard loss on the return. Pulley Banks after he muffs it.
Pulley Banks really just having a tough time back there. And the lighting, if you're not used to it, will play havoc with you sometimes. But Othello right there, starting free safety, also on special teams, doing a great job.
And Trendell Williams is back at quarterback. So Quincy Guy was the late first half quarterback, and it's back to Trendell Williams, who did move the ball club in half number one. Frank Davis split left. Arthur Davis, Jermaine Hill, Tim Ryan in the wishbone backfield on first down. Arthur Davis trying the right side, not much, maybe a couple. Mike Shalinski out of New Jersey. They're really beefed up in that weight room in the offseason. Very steady versus the run, had 36 tackles. There's Gene Murphy.
Again, 3 yards.
Yeah, UCLA's front seven, real strong front seven. Right now, Carrico Quinn is in there at one of the inside linebacker spots. I'm sorry, in place of Nkosi Littleton.
Nkosi Littleton.
Absolutely.
I was looking at you. Second down. Get him right. It's only the first one. Arthur Davis spins. Somebody had a shirt. That was Shalinski. He let it go. And Davis spun for a couple of more yards. Out close to the 34-yard line. Set up a third down. Here's where Fullerton has to start converting. They don't have much of a passing game, but when you get third and about this distance, you've got to be able to complete the pass. With this offense, you get behind. It's not a catch-up kind of an offense.
Not at all. If you get behind at all, and I think 20 points, 28 points is really the turning point. Fullerton was benefited by Quincy Guy's touchdown in the first half.
Third and six. Trendell Williams going to keep it. Flag down. Close to a first down. We may have a hold back around the 35-yard line. Othello Henderson led the charge for UCLA. And it is going against Fullerton.
Well, Trendell Williams really just has a great set of legs, but to counteract it, you're going to see number 9, Othello Henderson, coming from his free safety position. Really going to zero in right there on Trendell, and comes in and makes a fine tackle, helped out from the backside by big Jameer Miller, number 95.
What's going to eat it, Coach Murphy? I don't think the hold had much to do with the success of that play, as it was on the other side of the line. It'll be third down now and 16 for Trendell Williams. Jermaine Hill comes out of the ball game. Fullerton will send Davis to the top. Third down. Williams, quarterback draw, got some room. One man to beat. Now he's corralled at the 30-yard line. Had to get all the way up to the 40-yard line. Carrico Quinn for UCLA gathered him up, and it'll be fourth down, and Fullerton will have to punt. And Noel Prefontaine, who's had a sensational evening punting the football. Crowd of around 35,000, 40,000. Watch Terry Donahue, who was 10-6 in openers, as he begins his second decade guiding teams here in the Rose Bowl. Sean LaChapelle back to receive, standing at his own 28-yard line. Prefontaine, the total quarterback at DB in high school. Boots away, LaChapelle, good move. Cuts inside, midfield, and more. 40, 30, down to the 26-yard line. Sean LaChapelle, 37-yard punt, 40-yard return. And LaChapelle, for total yards tonight, he is racking them up. B.B. Hudson finally brought him down.
Well, you talk about big plays that'll change it. The looks of a game right here. Sean LaChapelle doing a great job cutting underneath his blocks, going against the grain now, and really causes a lot of problems for Fullerton in pursuit. Also a few problems for Al Jordan right there, number 12, trying to lay some blocks for Sean, but Sean doing a great job and a fine return. A
couple of years ago, Sean had problems back there receiving punts, one of the reasons why he was taken out of that position. Chad LaRose, you might remember, started last year, wasn't allowed to bring back the football. Now it's Sean LaChapelle's turn again to bring back punts. Don't you move. Back in a moment. 20-7 UCLA.
Yeah.
Funnily enough, there are approximately 1,500 minutes in a day, which means right now you can save about a dollar a minute with the $1,500 factory cash offer on a new Geo Storm. And get all this. Don't let another day or 1,500 minutes tick away before you take advantage of the $1,500 dollar a minute rebate on a Geo Storm at your Southern California Chevrolet Geo dealer.
Today in California, Gracie Balsams improved her crawl stroke. Up in Wairika, six children of the Karooks learned the traditions of their ancestors. Pacific Bell worked on an advanced monitoring system that will help smooth out traffic jams in L.A. Les Phillips built his dream car. It's just another day in California. Tomorrow will be better.
And the curtain up on the UCLA season, and what a great opening night for Sean LaChapelle, both receiving and returning punts. And he's got UCLA in good position now with that 40-yard return. It is 20-7 as we go back to the action. UCLA first down, Rob Walker the quarterback, 27-yard line, 11 minutes exactly to play third quarter. Kevin Williams, Khalif Carter in the backfield, and we got a flag.
Well, that play right there in the UCLA playbook is called on the line freeze. As you see, no one's moved. They still haven't moved, finally. Rob Walker doing a fine job. Every quarterback can use it at his discretion, check off at any play.
Dead ball, offside, defense. Still first down.
It's a good sign, Rob Walker using on the line freeze. Slow down a little overzealous defense of Fullerton.
Irritating Gene Murphy. Hey, he knows he's in this ball game. Last year, Fullerton went to Georgia, almost beat the Bulldogs between the hedges. They had the football with 2 minutes to play and down by six. Kevin Williams rides off a block, close to a first down, 15-yard line. Good patience that time by Kevin Williams around the right side.
I was going to say one of the most important aspects of Kevin Williams' tremendous running game is his ability to set up blocks, and right there running behind Khalif Carter, able to set up the block, cut underneath it, and make a first down out of the play.
Thomas Kale made the stop. Good numbers for Kevin Williams, included in that a 3-yard touchdown run in the first half. 20-7 UCLA. Walker with a first down at the 16. Williams stumbled a bit, nowhere to go. Down he goes at the 23-yard line.
Well, you remember a year ago, UCLA used so much shotgun formation. They had Maddox back in the shotgun formation. In this situation, it's what they would have been in a year ago. But Walker this time under center. They just want Williams to be more of a threat. This time, obviously, going backwards, not much of a threat.
This Fullerton defense has seen some great runners in the past. They played against Emmett Smith, Harvey Williams, Johnny Johnson. Not this particular set of defense, but Fullerton has seen some sensational runners over the years. Walker steps up, throws well short of his intended receiver, LaChapelle, as he took a hit delivering the football. It will be third down and long. 9:51 remaining in the third. UCLA in position here after a good punt return by Sean LaChapelle. Rob Walker at the helm, a redshirt freshman, 6'3", 198 pounds. Once again, Wayne Cook out with a sprained knee, will not return.
Right now, UCLA with its wide plan, Stokes, LaChapelle, and Jordan in the ball game.
Backs are split behind. Walker to the running back Williams, dancing along the sidelines, but he just couldn't hold his balance, and he's out of bounds at the 13-yard line, about 7 yards short of the first down. Lorenzo Haley coming up to make sure that Williams didn't stay in bounds.
Well, Walker probably doing the same thing, giving Perez a little bit more of a chip shot here, and looks down the field and comes off a nice throw to Williams, and Williams just unable to stay in bounds. Might have been able to get the first down had he stayed in, but that's a tough call there.
29-yard attempt for Luis Perez. He's already drilled two field goals. His career long is 44. He hit 43. This is 29. And this one is also good. So the steady Luis Perez tacks on another three rather for UCLA. And the score is 23-7. We'll take another break, 9:41 to play in the third.
You know, there's real magic in Diet Pepsi. It's got that special aha ingredient. The right one, baby. Okay, girls, now what's that magic ingredient?
Uh-huh. With 100% uh-huh.
During a crisis, people tend to pull together as a team. The Shanti Foundation team helps people face a crisis called AIDS. Find out what Shanti can do for you.
It's time to make your move.
The ball's in your court.
That'll be $62.75.
Do you take plastic?
Plastic. Master Plaster!
Ching!
The Recover Card.
Ching!
Ultimate expense. Gold! Ching! Platinum! Ching! Ching! Uranium! Ching!
Uranium?
Rallies still accepts cash. And very little of it. Rallies has it right.
We at Peyton Kramer Ford are totally committed to your satisfaction. You named us a member of Ford's exclusive Top 100 Club. We are one of the top 100 Ford dealerships in the country in customer satisfaction and sales. You honored us with the Distinguished Achievement Award. This award recognized Peyton Kramer Ford for consistently meeting or exceeding the needs and expectations of our customers. So drop by and see why our customers are satisfied customers.
From our family to your family.
Home of the soft sale, Peyton Kramer Ford, Redondo Beach.
If you saw San Diego State BYU Thursday, say no more. You're going to watch it next week. Bruins, BYU, it's Monday at 10:30 right here on Prime Ticket. That's our next telecast. Tom and I will be in Provo. Very much looking forward to that. The full moon shining down. The werewolf Tom Ramsey alongside. He is growing his fangs right now. That one's going to go out of bounds, flag down, and the Bruins will be penalized. 23-7. Eric Wright is the kickoff man right now for UCLA. And Terry Donahue, his Bruin team, a heavy, heavy favorite coming into this game. Right now, 23-7, and Fullerton, as they say, still in it. And the Titans will take it at the 35-yard line, and Trendale Williams will be in there for Gene Murphy. Gene Murphy, by the way, picked his team to be last again in the Big West because he wanted to be surprised also. A lot of people think, hey, this Fullerton team is not going to be last again in the Big West. Trendell, that quarterback. Keeps it up the middle. Where Quincy Guy found room on the touchdown run, Trendell Williams finds nothing. And down he goes. Wrapped up by that Bruin defense, which was eighth in the nation against the rush last year, second
Grady
in the Pac-10.
On the tackle.
Well, Grady Stretz getting his first taste of action this fall in the big number 77.
Again,
in a nose tackle behind Saleh Asaya.
We will see a lot of guys get work. By the way, let's talk about this option offense a little bit. It's really a combination, Tom, of four or five different schools of theories of VMI, Air Force, Hawaii, Southwest Texas, Oregon State. In fact, the coaching staff spent a week in Hawaii. Lucky them, learning the Hawaii option offense, and it's mostly a lot of their language.
I'm sure they were just locked in film rooms the whole time.
There's a bad pitch. Jameer Miller caused that one as he can. Eddie Lua wanted the football, couldn't get it. Loss on the play.
Well, big number 95 coming off the offside. He's going to put a big hit on Trendell. And right there, anytime you run the option, we're just talking about it, you want to force, as a defense, you want to force the other team into bad pitches, fumbles, this sort of thing, because the guys do carry the ball a little loosely.
Trendell Williams, here's a guy who always wanted to be a Titan. From Dominguez High, went to Titan games as a youngster. Not a lot of guys can say that. So he's been a Fullerton guy through and through, throughout his life, really. Now he is operating their offense. Trendell Williams, up the middle he goes, to the 29-yard line on third and long, and he's not going to get it. Nkosi Littleton, there for UCLA. It'll be a putting situation for the Titans.
Well, I think one of the reasons Trendrell Williams may have wanted to attend Cal State Fullerton, Damon Allen was a great quarterback for Cal State Fullerton back a few years, a younger brother of Marcus Allen. Damon Allen, of course, still doing well in the Canadian Football League, and still really, as Coach Gene Murphy put it, one of the most highly touted and well-respected athletes to come out of Fullerton.
Prefontaine to La Chapelle, who burned the special team for 40 yards last punt return. He's going at it again. Dancing around, he's going to get more. Down to the 46-yard line, Darius Watson to La Chapelle, showing that he can get it done, returning punts, 37-yard punt, a 20-yard return for La Chapelle. His numbers are going to be simply awesome at the end of this one.
Well, La Chapelle, 2 years ago, he fumbled the ball against Oklahoma in the opening game, and he never got another chance. And right here, I think Coach Donahue may have wished he might have given Sean a nice chance a year ago. Right there, another fine return.
Walker, the quarterback, Titan territory, 46-yard line. 216 all-purpose yards tonight. And we have 7:18 remaining third quarter. Kevin Williams hops, has some room. Kevin Williams may go. Down he goes at the 15-yard line. Dan Godfrey saves 31 yards on the play. So the captain of the Titans, the last line of defense, Kevin Williams, getting it done.
Well, I thought he was gone right here, Kevin Williams. A nice end zone shot here. A little delay give. Following Stevens. Khalif Carter right there, and really Williams did so much of it on his own. Slowed up just a little bit right there, but Godfrey there to make the tackle from behind.
Williams enters the year 15th on the all-time UCLA rushing list, just an average year of 1,000 yards the way he's going now, and he could move up to number 5. Right side, nothing there, spins, gets a couple, still down to the 15-yard line. Back to the original line of scrimmage, Al Witten. Talked about him. He got the taunting penalty earlier in the contest. He makes the stop.
Yeah, a year ago, Kevin Williams averaging 6 yards a carry, and I believe there was only 3 rushers in UCLA history, Theotis Brown, Wendell Tyler, Freeman McNeil, only to have higher rushing averages. And right there, Williams just tends to do something with nothing. And again, just a heck of a player.
Second down, La Chapelle to the right, Wynn left. That one's up the middle, fumble, and Fullerton's got it at the 10-yard line. So the Bruins turn it over, and Al Witten is on the football. So the Bruins driving, and Khalif Carter, the one who put the ball on the turf.
Well, Khalif Carter just giving a nice hole right there between Ron Nielsen and Aaron Gideon, and just can't really see what happens. It looked like Randy Strickland, number 98, stripped the ball away from Khalif. And Al Witten comes up with it.
Al Witten with the recovery, and Quincy Guy is back at quarterback. Much to the delight of the Fullerton faithful down to our left. Big roar out of them. At the 10. Guy, give it up the middle. Ryan, the fullback.
Tim Ryan,
who was a wrestler last year. And he's back playing football. He actually came to Fullerton to wrestle and to play football. And he strictly was a wrestler last year. Had 68 yards last week. Singled out by his coach, one of the stars, versus Northridge. Quincy Guy getting the play.
Go ahead.
Well, we were talking about this option offense that Fullerton's running. They ran an option. Think back now, Fullerton fans. Back in 77-78, Dale Bunn ran it and compiled nearly 3,000 total yards back in 77-78. So Fullerton has done this before. And Tim Ryan rumbling into the secondary for a first down. Marvin Goodwin, the tackle.
That's why Tim Ryan's in the ball game. Just a real steady, heady player. And the fullback is oh so important in this offense. And Coach Jim Chaney, again, just overemphasized to me and Bill McDonald all this week, the fullback and the quarterback are the two keys to this offense. And right there, they're getting a lot out of Tim Ryan.
Marvin Goodwin, the stop. Saw plenty of time last year as the Bruins played in those packages with five or six DBs. And Tim Ryan, another good game. First down, puts the guy at the helm. Keeps nowhere. Mike Cholinski again, who is really doing a disciplined job on the defensive line against this option for the Bruins.
Yeah, Mike Cholinski, very well respected by opposing coaches. He really has great technique. He's a big guy, and he really is ultra aggressive at the point of attack.
2 years off of major shoulder surgery.
I'm glad you said that.
You can fumble that very easily. Just like an option quarterback. Second down. 4:56, clock running, third quarter. Guy's found again, and down he goes. Sally Asaya. Big play by number 55. Running him down. There's Sally, played in four games last year. He will split time this year with Bruce Walker when Bruce gets healthy.
Sally lining up just inside Cholinski, number 98. Sally just running down Quincy Guy, making a big play. Matt Warner right there to congratulate him.
I tell you, if Quincy Watts was here, they'd be a little worried about him also. He could run a long way quickly. The gold medalist from USC.
You can tell I was watching the Olympics.
Ryan up the middle on third down, bangs his way out to the 30-yard line. Othello Henderson to tackle. Short of a first down, and Fullerton will have to punt. With 4 minutes remaining in the third quarter, UCLA up 23-7. Othello Henderson, the third leading tackler last year on this team, despite missing three full games. There's Mike Cholinski, who started his career at Pitt. Bert Grossman, foul plays for the Chargers. Prefontaine, been busy. So has this guy. La Chapelle. Flag down. Might have a hold. 32-yard line is all he gets to. 5-yard return, 41-yard boot. We'll check the flag.
David Brewinger on the tackle for the Titans.
David Brewinger made the tackle on La Chapelle.
Jeff Williamson assisting on the tackle.
Holding Bruins.
Penalty is indicated against the Bruins.
That was behind the play. And we will break away. We are at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, the opener for UCLA this year. They lead the Titans of Fullerton 23-7.
You know what makes Harrah's Casino Hotel so great? It's the people. They make you feel so good. No. Harrah's people are really fun. No, more like a family. Too formal. Too stiff. Harrah's people are like your best friends. They're always glad to see you. Come on, they're just beautiful. Now you're cooking. Get the picture? Ooh, that was neat. So what are you waiting for? Come to Harrah's Casino Hotels and see why we're the better people places. Folks like dancing?
Do you want your car done right?
Ein sehr guter Wechsel ist das same für einen Ölwechsel.
現代的なオイルチェンジの方法はジフィルーブを使うことです。ジフィルーブ
is so efficient.
That's a very good reason to bring your car to Jiffy Lube, America's favorite oil change.
We got experience. Jiffy Lube.
Slowing down, that ain't you. No, that's not you. Easy drinking beer, that silver bullet smooth.
Know where it's coming from, setting the mood. The pure taste of the Rockies and silver bullet smooth.
Make the move, Coors Lights, silver bullet smooth.
The question will be asked, will he be ready for BYU? That is Wayne Cook, the starting quarterback for UCLA, went out in the first half with a sprained knee. He is, of course, out for the game in his street clothes now. He was 8 for 13, 155 yards, and a touchdown to J.J. Stokes. He has been replaced by Rob Walker.
Boy, it's got to be really frustrating to wait so long then to get into the game and you're out in the first half after having a pretty decent first half.
LaChapelle and Jordan to the near side. On on the pitch on the option. Kevin Williams turning the corner, gets about 10 yards, close to a first down out to the 25-yard line. Run down by John Haynes, who earned the start this week for Fullerton with a fine effort versus Northridge. And Kevin Williams, more yardage, talking it up with B.B. Hudson. So is Khalif Carter. Bruins earning a lot of respect for these Fullerton Titans.
Gain of 9 yards.
Fullerton.
Second and one.
Next week, Georgia. Sacramento State, 2 weeks for them. UCLA next week. We've been mentioning BYU. And then right back here at the Rose Bowl in a couple of Saturdays. San Diego State before opening the conference down in Arizona first week of October. One wide receiver. That's LaChapelle on second and short. Give it to the fullback. That's Carter.
Carter, the ball carrier,
muscling his way. And he might have the first down. They're going to be very careful
first
with Khalif Carter this year because of that Achilles injury. Maybe 25, 30 snaps is the plan right now to make sure that he stays relatively healthy. Although we mentioned he won't be 100% this year because it's a lingering injury.
That's right. Khalif's had some problems with his feet. He had some problems with his arches breaking down. The Achilles stemmed from that, they believe, and just really kind of an agonizing thing for him.
Good enough for a first down. It's first and 10. Look out. Walker's hit, throws complete. Michael Wynn's got it out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Boy, Wynn took a pop but held on to the football, and so did Rob Walker. Second catch for Michael Wynn. Kerry Johns made the stop on the coverage.
Well, it's a great play by Mike Wynn and also by Rob Walker. Nice fake in the line of scrimmage. Rob keeps coming on it and fires away. And Mike Wynn really did a nice job coming back to the football, beating Darius Watson to the point and turning the ball upfield for a first down. Hello, college football. Rob Walker, of course, is blown off the screen. Yep, comes back in. He saw it, though. Completion.
You've got memories of that, very vivid.
No recollection.
And for Fullerton, Darius Watson, their all-conference DB, being helped off. He was tied for 16th in the nation in interceptions last year, Darius, so he is a talent to meet him in there. Wide receivers to the right. Up the middle. Big yardage for Kevin Williams. Across midfield, down to the 47-yard line. Al Witten bumps him off there. But more yards for Kevin Williams. He and LaChapelle last year combined, only the third time in Pac-10 history that one team had the leading rusher and receiver in the Pac-10.
Right here, point of attack, Vaughn Parker doing a great job up front. Derek Stevens, Aaron Gideon, Ron Nielsen, and Al Witten did get a good shot on Al. Kevin Williams, but not after he gained another first down.
Williams on 13 yards on that carry. Now over 100 yards, as you see, 20 for 105 and a score. Walker, plenty of room if he wants to run. He'll throw right at the line of scrimmage, and it's dropped by LaChapelle.
Intended for Sean LaChapelle.
In fact, he might have been across the line of scrimmage now that the flag is down. He was very close. I was going to give him the benefit of the doubt, and then came the hanky.
Legal forward pass is indicated.
And that is a loss of down, unfortunately, for the Bruins.
So this is going to go against UCLA. It is 23-7. It was 20-7 at the half. 2:29 remaining, third quarter. Bill McDonald, Tom Ramsey.
Penalty includes loss of down. Second down.
Thank you, Gordon Reese, for the call. And of course, Rob Walker, a little play action fake, came rolling out. He's waving to LaChapelle. Okay, dip back inside and, well, just a little late there. Burn it.
Field presence. Second down, 15 from the Bruins 48. Walker lost one up for Jordan. Too long. That'll be third down. Darius Watson back in.
Intended for Kevin Jordan
that time.
Well, if you're going to attack this defense, it's really where you want to go with the football. The corners play so far inside on this particular defense. They're really guarding against any post threat that the Bruins might throw at them. A corner route that time by Jordan and just overthrown by Rob Walker.
A lot of those post corners going to work. And the free safety acts more like a robber in there instead of a center fielder. He really cheats up on the slot receiver or the tight end. So I'm absolutely right. Those are the kind of pass routes that are going to work. over the middle. LaChapelle's got it short of a first down, leans towards it, going to be short. Needed to get to about the 37 and a half. He's just inside the 40. Dan Godfrey, and all of a sudden, the first time this year, crowd yelling, go, Terry.
Well, you really, fourth and a long 2.5, if that's possible.
Yeah, I can hear a long 2.5.
I think Terry is going to elect to go for it this time, at least maybe. Well, we're sending one of the go-to guys, Rick Daly, back in the ballgame. They already got the main go-to guy in the ballgame, so we'll see what happens.
LaChapelle coming this way. Ricky Davis is the setback, along with Carter. Give it to Ricky Davis. Got the first down.
Ricky Davis.
Tripped up in the backfield, kept his balance well, squirmed his way down to about the 36-yard line. First down, UCLA with a minute and a half.
First down, UCLA.
I really think that's a great call by Coach Donahue and Coach Smith right there. Rob Walker handing to Ricky Davis. Ricky Davis slashing behind Khalif Carter. Almost got tripped up. Aaron Gideon already pushed his man out of the way.
Gain of 3 yards.
Gain of 3 on the play. First down, UCLA. Williams now back in at the tailback. Fake to Williams and ducking for cover, Rob Walker.
David Brudinger. With the sack at the quarterback.
With the sack. Right on top of Rob like that. It'll be second down.
Walker that time just looked slow coming out from behind center. I'm not sure if someone stepped on his foot or if he was just slow in getting the ball from Gideon. Either way, Brudinger able to make the play for Fullerton.
From the 45.
Second down, 18 at the 45. Three wideouts for the Bruins. Backs are split. Walker to the near side. Got Jordan complete inside the 30, down to the 27-yard line. Mike Simmons on the coverage, but Kevin Jordan, 18 yards for the redshirt freshman, 6'1", 183, a real colt. Had a great spring, and now he's earned some time.
Well, Rob Walker doesn't have a lot of mustard on the ball here, but he ends up getting enough on it. It's not the prettiest pass we've ever seen, but then again, Tommy Maddox didn't throw some of the prettiest passes, but they seem to get there an awful lot of the time. And Jordan making a fine catch that time.
Jordan had knee surgery back in the summer of 1990, has come back well. Kevin Williams, Khalif Carter in the backfield. Williams right up the gut. Now trying to bounce outside. He's down at the 25-yard line. That's good enough for another UCLA first down. B.B. Hudson with the tackle. And that could be the final play here of quarter number 3 with UCLA on top, in control, 23-7. But Williams getting some good work here in week number 1.
Yeah, it really is. And that was a good second effort by Kevin Williams, already over the century mark for the evening. And again, just showing the extra effort, bouncing off the tackler, making the second and third guys tackle him. Good for the first down.
He had a big game last year against Oregon, 210 yards, 8th best in UCLA history. Mike Wayne, LaChapelle to the right, but it's given to Williams again. There he goes, down along the sideline, out of bounds at the 10. B.B. Hudson again has to drag down the tailback. 15 more for Kevin Williams.
Well, you can see how frustrated Kevin Williams is by not being able to bust that one for a touchdown. B.B. Hudson just hanging on to the shoestring. This time, Williams using a little straight arm there, almost breaks free, but Hudson says no way.
Well, you think of all the questions surrounding Kevin Williams at the beginning of last year. Has he blossomed? 22 carries, 123 yards. And if he can just stay healthy, durability the key. First and goal, UCLA. This will be the last play of the quarter, barring the penalty. Williams trying to turn the corner, can't. Down he goes at the line of scrimmage. John Haynes drags him down there. And that will do it for quarter number 3. When we come back, UCLA will have a second and goal. They lead 23-7. Stay with us, everybody.
It's Chevy Rock Solid Value Days. Now get low 2.9% GMAC financing on Chevy CK pickup. Rank the best full-size pickup by J.D. Power & Associates Initial Quality Study. At 2.9%, you'll save nearly $3,000 in finance charges on a new Chevy CK. Only during Rock Solid Value Days. The trucks you can depend on. The trucks that last.
Get the number one selling full-size truck in Southern California at your Southern California Chevrolet dealer now.
Slowing down.
that ain't you. No, no, that's not you. Easy drinking beer, that silver bullet smooth.
Know where it's coming from, setting the mood. The pure taste of the Rockies and silver bullet smooth.
Make the move, Coors Lights, silver bullet smooth.
I suppose getting older has its drawbacks. Your hair starts to get thin, you can't stay up for the late show. And spicy foods, forget them. But it's not all bad. When you turn 55, Great Western will give you a free checking account. Now, that'll save you money. It'll make you feel good. So if you're 55, talk to Great Western Bank. They've got 8 ways to get free checking. I'm going to do it in about 10 years.
This vehicle has a number of features that make it an extremely secure place to put money. So does this one. The Lexus LS400. With the highest retained value in its class, it's like money in the bank.
Back live at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, UCLA on top of Cal State Fullerton 23-7. And our UCLA quarter notes are being brought to you by Great Western. Wayne Cook out first half, sprained knee, on crutches right now. We don't know about his status for next week. Sean LaChapelle, great night, 228 all-purpose yards. And Kevin Williams over the century mark also has a 3-yard touchdown. Bill McDonald, Tom Ramsey, Dennis Munition, Luann Nasri, Johnny Dolak helping us out up here in the booth. On second down, the pitch goes.